show this week about a Norfolk family dealing with Alzheimer's. Plus, some highlights from the debate as well that we held on Friday.
Norfolk News, Norfolk Life. This is BBC Radio Norfolk.
It's 9 o'clock. The latest BBC Radio Norfolk news comes from Lucy Lightfoot.
Good morning. President Trump is to urge the leaders of 40 Muslim nations to join the fight against the threat from Islamist militants. Mr. Trump's on the second day of a visit to Saudi Arabia. Earlier this year, he was accused of inciting Islamophobia by his attempt to ban people from several Muslim-majority countries from travelling to the United States. Our security correspondent Frank Gardner is in Riyadh, where Mr. Trump will make his address.
Today is going to be a really tricky test for him. He's going to have to move very carefully in the way he delivers this very sensitive speech. You know, for any Western leader to come to a country like Saudi Arabia and address the leaders of more than 40 Muslim nations about Islam, their religion, this is sensitive stuff. But for Donald Trump, who tends to kind of go off script and shoot from the hip, this is very risky.
The leaders of the main parties will pause campaigning for an hour today to remember Jo Cox, the Labour MP who was shot and stabbed in her constituency in West Yorkshire last June. The candidates in Batley and Spen will join a cross-party fundraising event. Her husband Brendan says the gesture will send a powerful message of unity.
Jo would have been incredibly touched, both by the fact that all political parties are pausing for a moment, but also by the public reaction that there's been to the idea of the great get-together, the fact that people are jumping on this. Jo went into politics because of community. She wanted to draw communities closer together. That's what motivated her.
The future of prayer space for Muslims at the University of East Anglia remains uncertain. On Friday, weekly prayers were held outside in the main square as a show of solidarity against a decision to shut the usual worship area. Now, that decision comes just days before the holy month of Ramadan. The university says it offered the use of the multi-faith centre as an alternative. But Aya Delphi from the Islamic Society says that's just not good enough.
We pray five times a day. There are a lot of us on campus and we don't want to be disrespectful to other faiths that are using that space. We don't want to be taking over. There isn't appropriate facilities in terms of washing. It's in the bathrooms. In terms of segregation, in terms of space, it's just not suitable at all.
Train bosses say Greater Anglia passengers will benefit from 100,000 extra seats. The operator's summer timetable comes into effect from today. Extra seating will be on the Cambridge to London line, along with more Wi-Fi. A charity which organises social events for older people is planning to do more in Norfolk. Contact the Elderly has a group in Burnham Market and is now planning to start up in Great Yarmouth. It's planning a monthly tea party there. Johnny Wood from Cromer has just become the charity's development officer.
We're currently working on a group in Great Yarmouth. We've got a lovely bunch of volunteers who are nearly ready to go. We always welcome new volunteers as well, but as I say, we've got the volunteers and we're just finding out now about some of our local older guests who would like to come along. And we hope to be able to launch our first tea party group in Great Yarmouth in the next few weeks.
And big names, but not necessarily from the world of football, are preparing to take to the pitch at Carrow Road. Norwich City hosts Jamie's Game today, the annual celebrity match which raises money for the disabled and disadvantaged people living in Norfolk. This year's lineup features the likes of Callum Best and EastEnder Jake Wood. Organiser Darren Eady says it attracts a good crowd and raises much needed funds.
What it basically is to raise money for the Community Sports Foundation, which is the charity arm of the Norwich City Football Club, and they do fantastic work for disabled and disadvantaged people within Norfolk. Approached them 5 years ago after we'd done a couple of games elsewhere and pretty successful. And what we try and do is mix some former Norwich City players alongside different celebrities from all walks of life, from soap stars to musicians to reality TV stars.
BBC Radio Norfolk News, now with the sports headlines, here's Jay Lawrence.
It was a heartbreaking night for Cromer boxer Liam Walsh as he lost his bid to become world champion. He was beaten by American holder Gervonta Davis. There were better news for twin Ryan. He stopped Northern Ireland's Marco McCulloch in the 11th round to win the British Lonsdale belt outright. Norfolk's cricket team have a must-win game in the Unicorns Trophy today. Only victory at Cumberland would guarantee a place in the quarter-finals of the 50-over competition. In rugby union, Norfolk's Youngs brothers missed out on the Premiership final after their Leicester side lost 21-20 against Wasps. Ahead of the game, the Tigers players rallied around captain Tom Youngs, who led out his side just weeks after learning of his wife's terminal illness. And on the last day of the Premier League season, Liverpool just need to match Arsenal's result to ensure Champions League football next year. The Reds host relegated Middlesbrough, whilst the Gunners face Everton.
BBC Radio Norfolk weather.
Well, it's a beautiful day out there and it will continue. We're going to have sunshine right the way through the morning into the afternoon. The temperature across the Broads at the moment, 13 degrees. And we're expecting a high in Norwich later on of 18 or 19 degrees. So very pleasant indeed. And you won't need the brolly today and the winds are a lot lighter. Overnight tonight, plenty of clear sky. Don't despair, though. It's not going to be too chilly. I think many places actually will stay in double figures. It gets us off to a lovely start to the day tomorrow as well. Perhaps a little bit of cloud in the afternoon, particularly western parts of the county, but otherwise it's another fine and dry day, and if anything it will be a tiny bit warmer. So Thetford tomorrow, 21 degrees, but there will be one or two places that squeeze above that, I think. Then as we go through Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, even into Friday, this settled, dry and sunny weather continues, so it will feel very warm. The other side of that, of course, is that you will have to be careful of the UV levels, the pollen levels too, but it is going to be a little blast of summer as we go through this week. Now, the coastal waters from the Wash to Harwich, wind southwesterly 4 to 5, becoming 3 to 5. Gusts 28 knots, becoming 21 knots. Sea state slight, visibility very good. Wendy Hurrell with your BBC Radio Norfolk weather.
This is Mission Control. Fasten your seatbelts. Red 1, do you copy? This is going to be a bumpy ride.
Are you sitting comfortably? Then we'll begin.
Treasure Quest on BBC Radio Norfolk.
What a good morning, goodness me. Last week we were so close, weren't we? This close, a gnat's hair to getting it. 2 minutes. If we just had an extra 2 minutes, we may well have got the treasure last week, but okay, we didn't get it. And Sophie's so fed up with the fact that we didn't get it last week that she's off this week. But in her place, a worthy stand-in. In fact, she used to do the show, and she's done it. Well, we've done the show together as well, haven't we, Julie?
Hello, how are you?
All right, kiddo, how are you?
I'm ready to go.
Have you brought the weather with you, as crowded house?
I have. Gosh, it's gorgeous already. Wendy said it was 13, didn't she? But it feels a lot warmer than that.
Does it really?
Yeah.
Not in this
Graham
studio.
Has got the sun cream.
Yeah, so we've got Graham behind the wheel. So Graham, who's done this show, everyone... Do you know what? It's one big happy family, the Treasure Quest family. It's an extended family, dysfunctional, a bit like The Simpsons, I think.
No, we were so excited to see each other, weren't we, Graham?
This is history in the making. Treasure Quest is still making Treasure Quest history that is of interest to nobody other than people who listen and work on this show.
Which is a lot of people. A lot of people work on the show, that's for sure. But the brains behind it is the Questmaster. And he has reliably informed me this morning, as most weeks, we've got five clues. Five clues this week.
Oh.
And I know you're starting pretty local to the station, because I saw the radio car when I came in. So unless you've teleported to King's Lynn, you are...
You never know.
..in the vicinity. So come on, let's have your starting clue.
OK, well, we begin with a repeat performance. ...are still happening. I can see a building that's a good morning spread, and looking up, I can actually see the sun... and the moon.
Oh, OK. We had a bit of dropout there. We didn't hear all of that clue. Can you do it again?
Oh, no, that's a good start. OK. Well, we begin with...
Oh.
...where funny things are still happening. I can see a building that's a good morning spread, and looking up, I can actually see the sun and the moon.
01603 617321 is the number to call. Julie, you're not going to believe this. It dropped out again.
And no.
I'm not winding you up. This isn't me winding you up. Getting to do it again.
This is not a good omen. Oh,
I know.
Long
I have a
morning.
Reputation for winding people up, but you did actually.
Again?
Go on, one more time, please.
Okay. With a repeat performance, we begin where funny things are still happening. I can see a building that's a good morning spread, and looking up, I can actually see the sun. And the moon.
We heard every word. Thank you. 01603 617321 is the number to call. Where are Julie and Driver Graham starting today? 81333. Start your text with the word Norfolk. Get on the Facebook page and at BBC Norfolk on Twitter. Julie, one more time, if you please.
Okay, we begin with a repeat performance where funny things are still happening. I can see a building that's a good morning spread, and looking up, I can see the sun and the moon.
you know what? That song has just broken a dream I had last night. I dreamt that I made an hour-long documentary about the Rolling Stones, right? But then someone, a key member of the Rolling Stones, left before the programme was broadcast, and I had to re-edit it. And then I just said to the Questmaster, I just remembered who that... who that person was, and it was Mike Hicks, who does the Antiques phone-in on Matt Gudgeon's show. How bizarre is that?
No, he doesn't. No, we don't do the Antiques phone-in anymore.
Oh, do you? Oh, no. I used to do it, didn't you? No. Yeah, but with Mike, anyway. Yeah, with Mike. Yeah. Anyway, so we've got a bit of interference here.
No, well, we'll sort that in a second.
We'll put Julian down for a minute.
Yes, because... I'll tell you now, actually. We'll get it out of the way, because it's a bit of a surprise for you, David.
What's that?
The Julie is actually going to start right here in the studio with you.
Come in. Come in. Oh, I better give you a microphone, didn't I?
Hello.
I better give you a microphone. Where am I going to put you? I didn't realise this was happening.
No,
this
well, we thought, surprise. You know, just for a change.
Lovely to see you,
so
Julie.
So we've actually left Paul Graham out in the car, so it's very much kind of, pity Paul Graham. Paul Graham's a cold.
Hello. Good morning. Good morning.
How are you?
I'm all right. Nice to see you.
Well, I thought the signal was so good from right outside our building.
you thought you may as well just come in because you're literally outside.
Yeah. So, ready to go. Learned some lessons from last time. Don't keep helping myself from... the bag of VSAT sweeties.
Well, that's right, yeah, because you were kind of popping your hand into the glove box and getting a few treats.
Yeah.
And then
I felt very sick and I was slightly hyper by the end of the programme, sounding like some mad character out of EastEnders, screaming through the woods.
But that's part of the fun, Julie. That's part of it.
Yeah.
Well, you did it for so long, though.
Yeah, but it's changed. And there's the thing with the headphones, where now you have to swap headphones. And I get myself knitted to the VSAT.
Yeah, it's an interesting one, isn't it? I was surprised that we have to do this kind of changeover thing.
Oh, he goes on about this every week. You won't shut up about it till the engineers fix it.
What? Well, I like to make a point. And you know me. You know me. I like to go on and on and on about the same thing. Yeah.
Yeah. I wouldn't say that's what I've noticed.
You've not known me that long at all, have you?
No.
Everyone knows what I'm like, really.
By the way, I'm still on a technical note, so you don't get shocked when you walk out at the end. I've just turned your other headphones off because we could hear you through your other headphones,
I'm such a pro.
I think you're going to get an electric shock.
No.
Static, because I get that in the studio.
I get this whole building, I guess. Anyway, we're going to talk about chatting for 3 hours at this rate, aren't we?
Have they guessed?
I think lots of people
guessed. I think given the fact that you're here opposite me right now, few guesses. Not as many as I thought. Linda, Hillary, Colin, Wendy, Kathy, Phil says Julie might be in this place. Yeah. Belinda, they all say that you are in the forum.
There were a few more on Facebook as well. I didn't get time to put all the Facebook ones through this week, I'm afraid. Sorry about that, because I was sorting other bits and pieces out. So apologies to all the Facebook guesses I didn't get a chance to put through this week. Sorry.
Can I open the clue?
You can open the clue.
Yes.
Because
obviously
rules,
we're
stuck. Under the rules, yeah.
Oh, do we have to?
Yeah.
Every week?
Yeah, because we always have new listeners.
Can't we
There's always someone tuning in who's never heard the programme before.
Do them differently.
And
sing them.
Do them differently. I can't sing.
Well, that's a good idea, Julie. I like that. Yeah. I'm glad you're here.
No.
Maybe we could,
I'll give you the beat. There you go.
Okay. And I can't sing.
You'll go on. Give it a go.
No.
We'll do it like a barbershop quartet.
No, I'll do the Neil Tennant style. I'll just talk over the music.
Okay.
Now you've got until 12:05 to solve today's 5 clues and find the treasure somewhere in Norfolk or beyond. They have no maps or navigational aids of any kind in the radio car to assist them with this, just what's in their heads. David here in the studio does have a couple of maps. He has the laminated Big Norfolk Navigator and the Street Atlas. That's all the help he's allowed. He's not allowed to go online and look at Google or Wikipedia or Facebook or anything like that. He's entirely reliant on you. But you're a very good source of help. And what you can do is you can phone in, text in, email in, Facebook in the various ways David will describe. We mostly concentrate on the phone calls because it's nice to have you on air. You can explain yourself much more clearly. But we can't put every single call on air, of course, because we get so many. So we try and put through a balance. We put through some right answers. We put through some wrong answers. And it's up to David and Julie and Graham out in the car. Poor Graham stuck out there in the car.
To work it out.
To decide whose advice they'll follow and where they will go for the clues and the treasure. And as always, I have my two phone answers. We have Earl Grey Anna.
Yay!
And we have Highbrow Hannah with us today as well. We call her that because she speaks French and Italian. We're all very impressed.
And her surname's Armstrong, and there's a moon in the forum.
Well, there we go.
There we go.
See, there we are.
Check that out.
The moon's a balloon.
We did that especially for her.
Here are your maps and your copy of Clue 1.
Thank you very much. Well, I mean, you go. Julie has already got the Clue 1 open.
So away you go.
Okay, Clue 1. I'd like to solve one of these, won't we? I've done
okay,
one
off you go.
In the whole. Okay.
Over to you, Julie.
All right. Clue 1. The annual general meeting could mean a village of this name. An event you can make into a measurement has things you can cook or bring to.
Right, yeah. Clue 1. The annual general meeting, could be AGM, shortened to, could mean a village of this name.
an event you can make into a measurement. Hang on, an event you can make into a measurement. 100 metres is an event, isn't it? Maybe a sporting event. Has things you can cook or bring to. The annual general meeting could mean a village of this name. An event you can make into a measurement. Has things you can cook or bring to. Well, Julie's in the studio, so where do her and Graham go from here? 01603 617 321 81333. Start your text with the word Norfolk. Get on the Treasure Quest Facebook page, at BBC Norfolk on Twitter. Where do we go? So you said you wanted to solve one, so over to you. Julie
look
is going to... Julie
look
is going to solve this.
The usual blank.
Julie's going to solve this really quickly, I can just tell.
Yeah.
I can just tell. You come in here full of beans, ready to roll. When was the last... Because you and I have done one of these together. When was that? Because I lose track of time. It was February.
It was February,
apparently.
But it was a good omen. We started at the Forum.
Yeah. And, so, and we got the treasure, didn't we?
We did.
Yeah.
With a few minutes to spare.
Yeah.
I can't remember now.
A few minutes, yeah.
All I remember is that mad running at...
But you lost a glove, apparently, the Questmaster says.
Yes, and I don't know whether this was ever then said on air.
No, it wasn't, I
But
think.
I have to say a thank you to the gentleman who dropped my glove back after we put out an appeal and said, please, I love my blue woolen glove. Please, if
and
anyone
it
finds
back.
It. Yeah, and some gentleman brought it into the Forum.
The power of Treasure Quest, you see, in
there
BBC Radio Norfolk. And the kindness of people.
He didn't leave his name, but apparently he was tall and dark.
Well, there we are then.
According to Jane, the receptionist, I'm sure she can remember.
As he came in, there was an eclipse. She think he's tall and, yeah, and it's gone rather dark. Where do we go now? Clue one. The annual general meeting could mean a village of this name. An event you can make into a measurement has things you can cook or bring to. I'm opening the map, but I don't know why I'm bothering, really, because AGM could be the start, couldn't it? The annual general meeting.
Look, the girls are looking very blank. Is this what happens?
Yeah. Have you ever been in the studio?
No, never. This is a whole new experience.
Yeah. See, I need to go out on the road. I said that I will actually do the running 1 week. So I'd be happy to do that. So
I'd
I can kind of get the experience.
The car, but I've visa.
Okay. You can drive the car, and I'll do the running.
Oh my goodness! It's all.
Or I'll drive the car.
She talks.
I know.
The car talks.
Very,
which is
very scary. Very, very scary.
Yeah.
Susan in Overstrand. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning. Very well, thank you. Lovely day.
Lovely to hear from you as usual. What can you do for us?
Thank you. Well, I'm wondering if it's Arming Hall, which has an A and a G and an M in it, and it's not far from Norwich, it's south.
Oh, OK. So, yeah, you've
Arming
got the,
Hall.
The annual general meeting. So, yes, R-A-M-I-N-G-H.
It's not in that, the letters aren't in that order.
No, they're not, are they? So I think we need a bit more of that to kind of flesh that out a bit. But it's a good start though, Susan. The annual general meeting could mean a village of this name. Thank you for your call, Susan Overstrand. 01603 617321. I've got to be convinced of that. Haven't you, Arming Hall? Because you've got you got an A, an M, and the G in there. Could mean a village of this name.
I love the way you scowl in that.
Do you, see?
It's like when I read it out and I really sound like I know what I'm talking about.
You see, I don't realise I do all this. You see, the Questmaster sees me doing this because Sophie and you never see. Yes, David, trying to look intelligent. Trying as hard as he can. Richard and Deirdre, morning, sir.
Good morning.
Morning.
The second part of the clue,
yep.
The event you can make into a measurement, could that be a yard sale?
Oh, a yard sale.
Oh, I love
yes.
a yard sale.
That's a good one. That's
a... Bring to, or how you could make something and bring to a yard sale, perhaps.
Yeah, sorry, the last bit of... What? Sorry, I was listening to your ta-da then.
That's OK. Thank you very much for that.
No, thank you, Richard. So an event you made to measurement could be a yard sale. Has things you can cook or bring to. What about that bit?
Yeah, you could cook a cake and,
of course you can.
And take it to the sale. That sort
of course
of thing.
You could, yeah. Brilliant. Richard, thank you very much. Phil on Facebook says there's a yard sale and car boot at Arming Hall. Of course there is. That's a famous one, isn't it? So maybe Susan was right. I better sling her one of these, otherwise she'll get upset. Yard sale car boot, Arming Hall, contains the letters AGM. Don on Facebook says something beginning with A, at Great Milton, perhaps. Could be a yard sale, says Jeannie. It's car boot. Do they call it a yard sale, though, at Arming Hall?
No, it's a car boot.
It's a car boot, isn't it?
The last time I went to a car boot on Treasure Quest, we were there a long time.
Oh,
can
right.
you imagine? Every stall. Has anyone seen a brown
envelope? Everyone's going through it going, no.
But I can sell you. I'm really nice. Oh, lovely.
Could have brought some of your wares with you, Julie, to sell.
I love a good car boot.
They're great fun. I've done a car boot a few times.
I've done the one at Arming Hall.
Have you? Yeah, I've done the one at Arming Hall. It's very good.
Hold on. Where's mine?
What? I've got my coffee. I didn't know you were coming in, did I?
Don't I get a coffee?
Do you want a coffee?
Yeah.
You have a coffee. One of my, posh ones.
Oh, really? Oh, look at that.
Yeah, I have like my little filtered coffees thing.
Do you know what? I shouldn't. Graham will feel left out. And I've got...
That's the last one.
I have...
You can have it if you want.
No.
I don't
because
mind.
No, that's very kind, but I have my pepper... After the last sweetie experience, I have a much healthier...
We should not be giving you coffee, given your track record.
No.
Really,
I don't think. It's not. No, I have my peppermint and licorice tea in the car.
That sounds absolutely disgusting. right, where do we go? Do we go for Arming Hall? Do we go for Arming Hall? What
Anyone
do you
else
think?
Coming up with anything else?
And the fact that AGM is in there, I mean, you could say about a lot of places, couldn't you? Could mean a village of this name. An event you can make into a measurement yard sale. I like that. Cheryl from South Walsham says there's a garage sale in South Walsham. But how do we get South Walsham from that name?
That's quite a long way away.
You know when you had your opening clue earlier?
Yeah.
It says, they could text you, please say on air what the building is that sounds like a breakfast spread.
Oh, it's the Marmalade Factory. City Hall, a comedian once referred to it as the Marmalade Factory.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. I didn't say about those, did I? And no, I said it's a repeat performance because I'm...
You're back.
Starting at the same place. And yeah, where funny things are still happening because a funny thing happened on the way to the Forum is a film and musical from the early 1960s. And looking up, I could see the big moon.
The big moon. Well, look behind you. It's either in the reflection, you see.
Oh, wow.
It's quite disconcerting. It looks like it's coming towards you like some kind of apocalyptic movie, like Armageddon. Ray in Salhouse. Good morning. Good morning.
This is just a long shot.
Go for it.
But the measurement could be feet, F-E-E-T.
Yep.
You could change that to fate.
Ooh.
And A-G-M, a great Melton fate. That's a long shot.
A great...
It's on today at 1 o'clock.
A great Melton fate.
Yeah.
Why would we say it like that, though? But that's great. I love the idea of the feet and the fate. An event you can make into a measurement. Oh, I see. You can make that into a measurement.
Yeah.
I think that sounds more like it.
Say,
I think
on.
That sounds more like it. You can make it into a measurement.
So it doesn't start till 1 o'clock, but I expect they'll be getting ready.
Oh, they'll be getting ready. And Julie will need to help them with the bunting, I'm sure.
I love a bit of bunting.
She's good at things like that. Ray, thank you very much.
Okay.
Have a good day. Cheers, pal. Bye-bye. Okay, what do we do then? Do we go for Great Melton or do we go for Arming Hall?
No, look, I thought at this point I could turn round and look at the
questmaster. No.
And there would be some kind of sign on his face. There's nothing, is there?
No, it's poker face.
Look at that.
I mean, that is literally what I have to look at for 3 hours. I mean, that is the reaction I get, zero. Unless there's something funny and he chortles to himself and comes in to chip in.
Does he?
That's it. That's
now
what you get.
Now he's paying us no attention whatsoever.
Yeah, that's part of the game plan.
Is it?
Part of the game. Jane in Marlingford. Good morning, Jane.
Good morning. I think you should be going to Great Melton Fate.
And why do you think that?
You can change the word fake into feet.
Yeah, we got that. But you think great... Look, I think we're going to go for Great Melton. I think we've had quite a few people saying this now, and the fact that you've come through as well. I'm going to give you one of these, Jane. I'm going to get Julie to head for Great Melton. That's been lovely having a co-present with me in the studio.
How lovely. What a treat. What a treat.
maybe. I don't think it's been a treat for Julie, really.
No, it has. I know, really.
It's
honestly,
been really lovely to be
It's been amazing.
She's so sarcastic. Jane, thank you very much.
That's okay.
Cheers, then. Bye-bye. Right, we'll go for Great Melton then.
I better go. How do I turn this on? Westmaster.
It's a great start. Julie, it's lovely to see you. Yes. Nice to have you in the studio.
Well. I don't know where I'm going to end up, but have a good show.
Thank you. Well, you're on it as well, by the way. You're not just leaving now. That's not your bit done.
Look, I'm all tangled up already.
It's a great start. Great Melton.
Look at you with your map.
I know. I want you to realise that I do actually open the map and now I can vaguely read parts of it.
Do you? Oh, look at that face. Oh, priceless. Get me out of here quick.
You've seen that face before. You know, when I get slightly miffed.
Back on again.
There you go. All right, so I just
twiddle
that to her?
Yeah.
Right, you're going out on the B1108, Julie. Will you remember this?
I hope Graham's listening.
You're going out on the B1108, my darling. That's the way you're going. You're going through Earlham, through Colney, through Little Melton, and you get to Great Melton.
Oh, we went to Little Melton. Yeah,
but it's just beyond there.
Right.
Don't have too many sweets. Okay. Enjoy your peppermint and licorice tea. That's disgusting, doesn't it? Anyway, thank you very much. Off to Great Melton. It's been lovely having Julie in the studio. Genuinely, I mean that. Anyway, they're off. They're on their way. So, that's great. Thank you so much. I didn't think we'd crack that as quickly as we did. But, hopefully we're doing the right thing. Anyway,
because
sure we are.
Because you know I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, bass. Yeah, it's pretty clear. I'm all on by that bass, no trouble. I'm all on by that bass, no trouble. I'm all on by that bass. Hey. I'm bringing booty back. Go ahead and tell them skinny back. No, I'm just playing, I know y'all think you're fat. But I'm here to tell you, every inch of you is perfect from the bottom to the top. Yeah, my mama, she told me. I'm all on by that bass, no trouble. I'm all on by that bass, no trouble. I'm all on by that bass, because you know I'm all on by that bass, no trouble. I'm all on by that bass, no trouble. I'm all on by that bass, no trouble. I'm all on by that bass, because you know I'm all on by that bass, no trouble. I'm all on by that bass, no trouble. I'm all on by that bass, no trouble. I'm all on by that bass, by that bass.
Meghan Trainor, all about that bass. Well, Julie's on her way with Driver Graham. Got to come up with a better name than that, haven't we? Lovely to have Julie in the studio, and now they're on their way to Great Melton, thanks to you.
BBC Radio Norfolk Sport.
It's Jam Master Jay. Morning, Jay.
Good morning. There was disappointment for Cromer's Liam Walsh as he lost in his bid to become world champion. The boxer was stopped in the third round by defending champ Gervonta Davis after a flurry of brutal punches at the Copper Box Arena in London. There were better news for a twin Ryan. He stopped Northern Ireland's Marco McCulloch in the 11th round to win the British Lonsdale belt outright. And Ryan says he couldn't have been better prepared.
The camp was perfect. It's the fittest I've ever been in my life. The best I've ever made the weight. And I just credit Marco for his toughness. He was a very tough lad. He used the ropes well. If I could have caught him in the middle of the ring, I think I might have been able to get him over. But he's a very tough man. Hit him with shots that just dropped a lot of my other opponents. It's one of the first featherweights I haven't put over. So fair play to him for that.
The Premier League season comes to an end today with the battle for the fourth Champions League place being settled. Arsenal are in fifth, 1 point behind fourth place Liverpool and three adrift of Manchester City in third. If Liverpool beat relegated Middlesbrough at Anfield and City avoid losing at Watford, then even if Arsenal defeat Everton at the Emirates, Arsene Wenger will be consigned to playing in the Europa League. Norfolk's cricket team have a must-win game in the Unicorns Trophy today. Only victory at Cumberland would guarantee a place in the quarter-finals of the 50-over competition. Swanson's batsman Jason Reynolds will be making his Norfolk debut.
I'm absolutely chuffed about this call-up. It was always one of my goals. Ever since we sort of finished youth cricket at the under-17, under-19 level, I knew Lions was there, but I was always looking beyond that next step. And I work quite closely with Brownie in that, and he's always been in my ear. This is where I want to be going, and this is my next step. So I'm really chuffed it's happened, and hopefully I can now help the lads get a good win in a must-win game.
Horsford beat Vauxhall Mallards by just 7 runs in a thrilling Norfolk derby in cricket's East Anglian Premier League. The home side were bowled all out for 101 at Manor Park, but then dismissed Mallards for 94. Reigning champs Swarston kept up their perfect start to the season by beating Cambridge Granter, but Great Witchingham suffered their first defeat of the campaign at Sudbury. Norwich achieved 221 for 9 in 50 overs, but Burwell managed the win after they scored 192 for 3 in 33 overs. There'll be more BBC Radio Norfolk Sport tomorrow morning.
Jam Master Jay, thank you.
I need to come up with a hip hop name for you.
No, you,
David.
No, just stop there. Stop there.
Treasure Quest on BBC Radio Norfolk.
Well, we're not going to allow that at all. Just come up to 25 to 10. It is Treasure Quest Sunday morning here on BBC Radio Norfolk with David Whiteley, and this week with Julie Ranger. And Julie and driver Graham are on their way to Great Melton. This is clue one. The annual general meeting could mean a village of this name. The AGM, a Great Melton, an event you can make into a measurement of fate. Because you can make it into feet, has things you can cook or bring to. So maybe there's a bring and buy sale there as well, potentially, at Great Melton. Anyway, Julie and Graham are on their way, aren't you?
Hello, yeah, we are. Although we've just taken a slight detour, haven't we, Graham?
Now the speed limiter's come on. I can't go above 18 miles an hour.
You're kidding me.
I don't know what that's about.
Oh, my goodness.
What happened? The radio car says you can't go above 18 miles an hour.
We might have to think carefully about how the rest of the programme pans out.
Are you going 18 miles an hour?
Can we really not go above 18 miles an hour? Seriously.
I don't know what's going on.
We can't.
What day is it today?
Can we go above 20?
Well, we're doing 25 now.
Okay.
But there's strange lights coming on the dashboard that I haven't seen before because my old car hasn't got one.
Oh, blimey, O'Reilly.
That's a good start, isn't it? It's a great start.
It is.
You should have just... Now. In you should.
30. Yay! Oh, this could be a very long morning.
You should have just stayed in the studio.
Yeah, we could have done the whole thing from there.
I'm not sure either. We could have done a virtual treasure quest, done it on the map.
We're on the Unthank Road.
Okay, so you've got quite a way to go before you get to Great... Do you know how to get to Great Melton? Do you need directions?
Do you know how to get to Great Melton? Ish.
Okay, hang on.
I think I know Little Melton.
Oh, well, yeah, well, it's just after there.
I know
there.
How to get to Little Melton. Yeah, it is. Just beyond,
just
Graham.
Beyond there. So
I forget, because he can't hear, so I have to... translate, don't I, and make notes of where we're going.
It's incredible.
You know,
Sophie,
what my brain's
Sophie's
like.
Sophie's been doing this show for a long time, and it's only a few weeks ago she decided to make notes for the first time, and she's found it revolutionary.
Although I was very organised and packed a pen, and now I can't find it. Where's it gone? I can't. Oh, there's another one here. Let's have that one. Right.
Okay. So shall I give you? Do you want to write these down then, Julie? Shall I give you the directions?
Yeah, just let's practice.
Okay.
For when
I think
it gets
you might have
really
the other microphone on. Actually,
later.
Is the other microphone on? It sounds very. Well, have you got the door open? You know, you've got your head out the window, have you? It's very noisy.
No, I promise, I'm not like a little dog with my tongue out the window. No. Sorry. The problem is what you can't hear
that's
me very
better,
well.
That's better. I can hear you better now.
Oh, okay. Well, the problem is I've had to move the mic away from my mouth because I'm so loud in my headset. We're going to have to speak off air to somebody because I'm so loud, it's deafening.
And you can't
so
turn it down.
If I hold the mic away, no, we don't know how.
Okay. Well, it's the blind leading the blind today, isn't it, really?
So now I'm absolutely deafening myself, but if I take my headphones off, I can't hear you. So
that's not a bad thing. Right, let's talk to Hilary in Cromart. Morning, Hilary.
Morning, David.
How are you?
I'm fine. Nice to talk to you.
You too. How are you?
Yes, I'm well. You'd have a lovely time. It's brilliant up here today.
Oh, don't tell me. There's no waves, though, are there? There are no waves.
No waves, all right.
Okay, that's fine. No. That's fine. I'm not missing anything. So tell me, what do you think, then? Do you think we're going to the right place?
You say it's bring to or make.
Yes.
And at Good Fates, they always have cake stalls. They're a major event.
Yeah.
And I'm wondering if it's there, it's going to have a cake stall for people to buy, but also possibly alongside it, cake making.
Oh.
Possibly... for children, or, you know, making cakes, bake-off type thing.
Maybe that's not a bad idea, actually. I'm going to give you one of these for your trouble. And I also think that Julie might actually have to bake a cake.
Well, exactly. You know, and then we can put on cake bake, you know, the cake programmes.
Oh, yeah. well, depends which one, because the BBC lost one of them. We lost the tent.
And
Paul Hollywood.
So we don't speak about them anymore.
No, we don't speak about them anymore. So we don't talk about the war. We don't talk about the Great British Bake Off anymore.
No, quite.
Okay.
No. But also, if she bakes it, that means both of them can have a little sample, can't they?
They can. And she can wash it down with her peppermint and licorice tea.
Yes.
Sounds vile, doesn't it, Hilary?
We'll see how it goes.
Hilary, thanks ever so much for calling. Maybe Julie's got to bake a cake. Julie, you've probably got to bake a cake.
Baking? No, my cooking is not great, but my baking's okay.
So you can bake a cake.
So, you know.
So you can maybe bake a cake.
They're edible.
Yeah, that's good. That's a good start. So Hilary thinks you might have to be baking a cake.
Excellent. Stop insulting my tea. You need to try one.
Do you know the thing about...
I should have brought my cup with me and you would have made you sample it on air. I think you'd like it.
You know those things about the fruit?
I think you're being very judgmental.
No, I'm not. I've tried these things before and I always think that fruit teas smell great, but then they're a bit of a letdown when you have them.
No. This one isn't.
Really?
And I get where you're coming from. No, I promise. I'm going to bring one in tomorrow.
Bring one in tomorrow.
You.
Okay.
Are you on shift tomorrow?
Well, yes, I might be in the building. Am I on shift? who knows?
Yes, I might show my face.
Let me check my own timetable. Yes, I'll be in. I'll be in tomorrow. So I'm looking forward to sampling. I think he says with trepidation. Peppermint.
I'm going to get Graham to try it, and then have you ever had a peppermint and licorice tea?
I have.
Oh, now, did you like it?
No, not really. The peppermint's
nice,
the licorice ones.
Look, can't you just lie?
You
can imagine how smug he's sounding now in my ear. Just agree with me. Oh, it was lovely, Jules. It was taste divine.
Graham's always been my favourite. He's always been my favourite, has Graham. Coming back to you in a minute.
Just said, morning from 10. Join me, Chrissy Jackson, when we talk about things like this.
One of the ferrets dug itself out of its home. She put it on Facebook, and about a week later, one of her friends in the next village, which is about 2 to 3 miles away, said, I think we found your ferret. How it got there, we will never know, but obviously, in the big scheme of things, 2 or 3 miles from a ferret is quite a long way.
And on Monday's show, we'll be live from the Chelsea Flower Show, and Brett will be back with his guide to the best TV for the week ahead. So join me, Chrissy Jackson, Monday morning, 10 till 1, on BBC Radio Norfolk, your part of the BBC.
BBC Radio Norfolk Travel.
Right, it's 20 to 10. Here's Howard with the travel. Morning, Howard.
Good morning. Well, firstly, the main routes. Not reporting any delays across the A47 so far in Norwich. There are works on All Saints Green in both directions between Queen's Road and Wessel Gate. In Sporrel, temporary lights on Castle Acre Road near the A47. And in Horsford, Drayton Lane is shut today between Church Street and Reefham Road. As for trains, there's no delays running across Greater Anglia lines currently, and the Norwich and Norfolk Festival continues today just around the city centre now. If you see anything or can update me, call 01603 617 321. I'm Howard Kassam with your BBC Radio Norfolk Travel.
Okay, Julie and Graham are on their way to Great Melton. I think we might have just lost the signal. But Phil on Facebook says, go to the church fete at the Cricket Pavilion on Hall Road at Great Melton. Phil, thank you. And Jeannie says, could there be a book table? You can cook the books. Of course you can. And you can bring something to the table. Jeannie, thank you. So maybe we're looking for a bookstore, or maybe we're looking for a cake stall. Hilary and Cromer thought we may be looking for a cake stall. But you've been amazing this morning, so quick. And Julie started off right here in the studio, and her and Graham are on their way to Great Melton. This is clue one. The annual general meeting could mean a village of this name, an event you can make into a measurement, has things you can cook or bring to. AGM, we think a Great Melton. Could mean a village of this name. So we're heading to Great Melton. An event you can make into a measurement. A fete you can make into a measurement. Feet has things you can cook.
David.
Yes, I'm listening.
David.
Yes, I'm here.
Hello. Sorry, do we just stay on the main road? We've just passed the turn to Little Melton.
Yeah,
do we
keep
just
going.
Stay on the main
keep
road?
Going. Yeah, Diana has called and says, ignore the turnings to Little Melton and then take the third turning signpost at Great Melton.
We need the third turning signpost at Great Melton, Graham.
Third turning.
Third is in Great Melton. Oh, I've lost him.
No, I'm here.
Oh, are you?
Still
Hello,
here.
Do we know where the fate is?
It is on, it's at the Cricket Pavilion on Hall Road.
The Cricket Pavilion on Hall Road, did you say?
Yeah, Hall Road in Great Melton. I mean, Great Melton isn't a massive place. I'm hoping that the fate will be signed, or you'll see the big cricket pitch. Cricket Pavilion.
If not, I will just stick my head out the window and shout to somebody, politely.
That always works.
Hello!
Always works.
Hi.
Tim on Facebook says, I've solved the fruit tea taste problem. You put a spoonful of sugar in. I think it kind of defeats the object, Tim.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's supposed to be healthy.
It does taste a bit nicer. Well, sun is shining. I'm feeling confident.
Well, I'm glad you are.
Oh, hello. I've lost him again.
No, I'm still here. I'm still here. I'm listening to you.
This is brilliant.
I'm listening to your pearls of wisdom. So you go.
That's why there's dead air. It's just complete dead air.
Well,
there's pearls of wisdom that come along every
couple of hours. So we've got plenty of time. Plenty of time for the pearls of wisdom to come out. So you've been past Little Melton. You're not far then. So you should be coming to Great Melton very shortly.
Yeah, I think we're just about to come up to the turning, aren't we? Is it this crossroads here? Hold on, Graham. This might... Rightly. Does that say Great Melton? Oh, the signpost has been snapped off. Oh, but there's a fate sign.
Oh, there we go. That's good.
Fate this Sunday arrow. Oh, which all...
That's rather handy.
Hall Road. Sign Hall Road. Perfect. Sign for fate.
Thank
Jobs
you, Phil.
Jobs are good'un. That is brilliant. Well...
Well, Judy,
yeah, feeling positive.
When you get there, we think you're looking for either a cake stall or maybe a bookstall.
Well, a bookstall? Why the bookstall? I missed that bit.
Well, Jeannie takes in...
What
said
about
it could,
cake, maybe?
Yeah, the last line says, has things you can cook or bring to. You could cook the books and bring something to the table, you see. So maybe it's a book table.
So which one do you want me to go for first?
Well, let's try the cake one first. I'm hoping it's not too big a place. And the fate isn't spread out across to a larger area. And you can scoot around it rather quickly.
Oh, cake. Are you hungry, Graham?
Starving.
Have you had any breakfast?
Some, but that was a couple of hours ago.
I know, that's the thing, isn't it? You have breakfast at like 5 o'clock in the morning.
So it's quarter to 11s, or it's quarter to 10s for 11s.
Yeah, it's lunchtime, really.
I mean, Treasure Quest, which is basically...
Of all the sweets... It is. Where are the sweets? I know we said we wouldn't, but just in case we get really... Oh, dear, what have I done there? Broken the car already. Sweeties.
Well, an old sweet wrapper here that someone's left in from sport yesterday.
Is that it?
Inside.
I think the sweet bag has gone. Well, that's probably a good thing, isn't it? Oh, OK, well, I've got some plain biscuits.
We'll get some cake. Let them eat cake.
OK.
Right, OK, well, hang on. Hold your horses on cake, because Jeannie has texted again. And I'm about to give her a ta-da here, because further to my text about books, I've realised there's also the expression, bring to book. Has to be book, because you've got things you can cook. You can cook the books or bring to
hold on,
book.
Is that an arrow? Hold on. No, it's that way.
So I think we're going to go for... Jeannie, this is for you. I think we're going to go for where they're selling books at the fate.
Okay. All right, straight to the bookstore.
So you might not be able to have... you might get time for cake, but I don't think you're going to have to bake
don't
one.
Don't know. We need to... Yeah, no time for cooking, no time for eating, just on with the next clue.
That's what you've got your peppermint and licorice tea for. That is your sustenance.
Yes. Yeah, and my plain biscuits, which I think Graham is just going to have to put up with. Because we're going to solve the clue. So hold on, fate here. What? Stop the car. Oh, look, we can turn round.
It's like a carry-on film, isn't it?
Okay. Oh, reversing.
This vehicle is reversing.
Oh, look at the bunting. Oh, Union Jack bunting. Proper fate. Well done, Great Melton. Here we go. Okay. So we need to find... Oh, look, they're busy already. Morning, everyone. Hello. Hi. Okay. Car park. I don't think we can drive here, Graham. That's a cricket pitch. Don't drive on there.
Oh, stop here.
Okay.
The groundsman will lose his temper.
We're going to get... I know. Right. Now, this is where we need to swap.
Switcheroo.
Okay. Hold on a minute.
Like a quiet
I'm note. Swapping. Put my peppermint tea down. Headphones off. Drop mic. Headphones on. Pick up other mic. Right. Hold on, I'm stuck.
It's all right, we're holding on, don't worry. If you could... Oh, there she's gone now. She's switching over to the other microphone. I don't understand why we have to do this. All this technology and we have to do this. Ludicrous. If I say it enough, then someone may actually do something about it. But they probably won't. Yeah. Yeah, okay. Yeah, all right. Fair enough. There's technical reasons, the Questmaster just said in my ears, to do with the satellite, etc. Where's she switching over to? Another channel?
Anglia.
She's on Anglia.
That be.
Oh, there you are.
Be
inside. Okay, let me head into the pavilion. Good morning. Hello. Hi. Morning, everybody. Right, I've come into the main cricket pavilion and I can see lots of books.
Oh,
would you mind? Can we just knock the radio off? That's lovely. Right, loads of books. Loads of books. And, oh, look what I found. Clue 2.
Woo, nice one.
Good work, everybody. We got it.
So quickly, Ranger.
I can't hear a thing, so I'm going to go and head outside because I'm sure we're getting a huge fanfare at this
point.
Are. Graham, no idea.
You are. And she's got clue two. That, I can't believe that's fantastic.
Yeah, there we go.
And before 10 to 10.
We better go through clue one.
Get through clue one while Julie. Yeah, yeah. Oh, no, she's there. She's there. Could you
hello,
hear her?
I'm back on.
We got you. Well, can you read clue two quickly before we go through clue one?
Okay, hold on. Let's open
well done,
the envelope.
Julie. That was brilliant.
Yay.
Nice one. You see, it's like riding a
and
bike,
by the
this
end of
show.
The show,
you
the
never
whole
forget.
Switcherooing and you know,
on,
the general competence will have... All right, there we go. Clue two. A place that perhaps combines the concerns of one pert we played, similar to a swap shop, is Philip or Jason here? For goodness sake.
Did you say Pertwee?
No, that for goodness
Pertwee.
Sake wasn't... She made
is that
it sound,
Sean Pertwee?
Or one she made it sound like for goodness sake was part of the clue there. I just said that's not part of the... That's not the last line of the clue.
Yeah, that's not for goodness sake is the last... Yeah. Well, wasn't he a Doctor
it's
Who as well?
For goodness sake, one what on earth does this mean?
Yeah, well, Pertwee, and given the Questmaster loves Doctor Who, didn't one of the... Didn't, I can't remember his first name. That Pertwee played Doctor Who. So maybe that's...
But no, I want a Wurzel Gummidge clue.
Well, they absolutely.
A place that perhaps combines the concerns of one pert we played, similar to a swap shop, is Philip or Jason here? I like the fact he used to swap his heads.
Oh, he did, didn't he?
He used to completely freak out my sister.
Yeah, well, freaked out most kids, didn't it? There's some freaky kids TV shows. Right, let's go through clue one then, Questmaster. The annual general meeting could mean a village of this name.
Yes, the AGM. So it could be a village that's AGM, Great Melton. So you're looking for a GM.
Okay, an event you can make into a measurement.
Yes, as people got fate, can be an anagram of feet.
Very good. Has things you can cook or bring to.
You can cook the books if you're being slightly dodgy with your accounting, or you can bring someone to book. They were brought to book. So
Genie, well done
the
for that.
The books are Great Melton. They're busy setting up there. The fate, I think, is on this afternoon, but they're getting things underway, so getting it all set up and ready to go. I'm sure they'll tell you a bit about when it's on and so forth and what they're raising money for, but there's clue two.
Questmaster, thank you very much. I'll read clue two, and then, Julie, you can find out a bit more about the Great Melton fate that starts this afternoon at 1 o'clock. Right, clue two. A place that perhaps combines the concerns of one Pertwee played. The concerns of one Pertwee played. It's got to be Wurzel Gummidge, isn't it? As you said, Julie. He played Wurzel Gummidge, didn't he? Similar to a swap shop, that was Noel Edmonds. Is Philip or Jason here? Philip Schofield, maybe? Jason Donovan? I'm trying to think of that kind of era. A place that perhaps combines the concerns of one Pertwee played, similar to a swap shop, is Philip or Jason here? What was Wurzel Gummidge concerned about? I can't remember. I'm too young to remember, obviously. 01603 617321 or drop us a text 81333. Start your text with the word Norfolk. Pile in the conversation on the Facebook page or at BBC Norfolk on Twitter. Julie, over to you about the
Hello.
Fate today.
Hi, I've got to find it. Hello.
Morning.
What's your name?
I'm Mary.
Hi, Mary. So your fate today, what time does it start?
It starts at 1 and it goes on to about 4. And we've got the Helsden and Sprouston band coming and they'll be playing. And we've got a lovely sunny day, so what more could we want? Lots of traditional games for the children. And there's bowls and lots of teas. And, it'll be an incredible day. A fun family day, we call it.
Brilliant. And what are you raising money for?
Well, raising money, it's organised by the church, but we do, it's a community thing. But our specific this year is we need to restore our organ. And our organist is here, and she will be very pleased if people will come and put pennies in to restore her organ.
So is your organ not in a great state at the moment? Is it playable at all?
It's playable, but it's something to do with, she'll explain it, but basically she can't do the quiet and soft, so we have to have everything loud. So, so she gets very stressed about it.
It's a bit like being on this programme. Everything in my headphones at the moment is so loud. Oh. It's incredible. OK, so that's what you're raising funds for this afternoon.
Specifically. Yes.
And I'll take the credit for the weather at the moment. It's glorious, isn't it?
Couldn't be better.
Much more have you got to do? You seem quite organised already.
Yeah, we've got another tent to go up to put the band in, but, you know, the lady's setting up the tombola here and the plant stall, and then we'll have a bring and buy, fabulous raffle, then... Yeah.
She keeps shouting about her tombola. She's determined to get that in, isn't she?
Winners every time, she's saying, on the children, or the junior,
brilliant.
The junior tombola.
Oh, that's good.
And we have, you know, the target football there for the, you know, the boys that like to be a little bit aggressive. And there's a cricket match going on around the corner. So it's just a lovely setting. We just love it.
Well, I hope you have a fantastic time. Do you think you can help with this clue? Do you want to read it out, first of all, and then give me your thoughts?
Oh, my goodness. Okay.
That was my reaction.
I'll get John to help me. A place that perhaps combines the concerns of one Pertwee played, similar to a swap shop, is Philip or Jason here? Okay, so swap shop.
Noel Edmonds, wasn't it? Noel Edmonds on swap shop. Mm. Saturday swap shop. Mark in Lowestoft is always very good. Mark, good morning.
Good morning, David. Morning, Julie.
How are you, sir?
Fine, thank you very much. Thank you. I was just thinking of the last two lines. Philip Schofield and Jason Donovan played Joseph in the West End for the multicoloured, for the Dream Coat. So I'm just thinking if there's a link in there with swap shop, multicoloured.
I wore my coat, I closed my eyes. Mark, thank you very much. Yes, so maybe it was Joseph and the Technicolour Dream Coat, something to do with that.
Yes, gosh, yeah, I don't know what, though. Well,
maybe
is there
somebody
a performance on somewhere?
There might be, yeah.
Yeah, the only place I could find was Wyndham Central Hall in Wyndham. They're doing Joseph in July. So
well, they might be rehearsing.
Unless they're cracked. Yeah, unless they're rehearsing, but it seems a long way off.
They might want to get the rehearsals in early. Mark, thank you very much.
Okay, no worries.
Come on, thank you. Michelle thinks the same, thinks the clue has something to do with Joseph as well. And David in Downham Market. Morning, David.
Yeah, I'm basically of the same agreement with multicoloured swap shop. That was the original name of it.
Of course it was.
Multicoloured swap shop. And Joseph had a Technicolour dream coat. So and John Pertwee playing Wurzel Gummidge at a scarecrow. So you're probably looking for a scarecrow event.
Yes.
And the scarecrow wearing a multicoloured coat.
You may have nailed it there, actually, Dave.
I don't know the actual place.
No, but you've nailed 2, 3, and 4.
Hopefully.
Lines 2, 3, and 4. So I'm going to give you one of the. Have one of these, sir, for your time. Thank you very much.
First one from you, Dave.
Oh, we'll have one more. Have another
Excellent.
One. Have another. I'm feeling generous. Right. The weather's good. Thanks to Julie.
Marvellous.
David, thank you very much. Have
You're
a good
welcome.
Day. Cheers, buddy. Tina on Facebook. Wasn't Wurzel Gummidge worried about losing his head? Yes, he was. That was a concern of his, wasn't it? So you said he used to swap his head, didn't he, Julie? Used to change.
He used to have
heads.
Lots of different heads that he could put on Wurzel Gummidge.
I know people we work with like that.
I was going to say something else then, but I'm not going to.
Which face are you wearing today? Here we go. not you. Jason Donovan and Philip Schofield both played Joseph and his amazing Technicolour dream coat. Pete says, Pete from Jarrantry. Morning, Pete. Thank you. And Daniel on Facebook.
So we need to find... Are we thinking we need to find a scarecrow
Possibly.
Festival
A scarecrow,
somewhere?
Yeah. And what David and Downham Market were saying there as well is that maybe we're looking for somebody, a scarecrow wearing something multicoloured.
Multicoloured dream coat.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought we were going to go to rehearsal. We could listen.
Ah,
to
hang on.
Some
Here we
of
go.
The, oh, that would be great.
It might not be Wurzel Gummidge. It could be Bill Pertwee. Now, Bill Pertwee, of course, was Warden Hodges in Dad's Army.
Ah, okay.
Which we don't see enough of on BBC Two, I don't think. So Warden Hodges, of course, was played by Bill Pertwee. Here we go. Alison
says, "Oh, look at Graham. He's so sensible.
What's he doing now?
Look at him.
What's he doing?
He's putting on his sun cream.
Factor 30.
You're such a good boy.
No, you should. You should. Slip,
look
slop,
at that.
Slap.
There you go. He looks like something straight out of Top Gun this morning with his glasses on and his collar all. Where's your bike?
Can you do my neck, Julie?
Yeah, there we go.
Do we know each other well enough?
We do. Jeez. There we go.
Oh, Julie.
Do you want, oh, there we go.
I know
do you
men
want me
would pay
bit,
for that.
Do you want me to do a bit on top?
Well, I'll just spray it on my bald patch. Yeah,
no, I was being polite. No, don't. Oh, look, it's all gone in your hair now. There we go.
I thought he was going to say something else then. Right, OK.
There we are.
I'm slightly worried about where that was going. Right.
Yeah, so was I.
Split on my bald patch. Good.
There's something about Mary.
A place that perhaps combines the concerns
that.
Of one Pertwee played, similar to a swap shop. Is Philip or Jason here? 01603 617321. Where do we go? It sounds like we've cracked the second part of the clue.
Well, that smells lovely. You're very fragrant. Yeah, I think I do. No, hold on a minute. What's it got in it?
Oh, yeah. Well, you look at the ingredients.
There's a patch. There's a big sticker over it. Your security sticker's in the wrong place.
We'll get it off if you can.
Okay. It does
smell nice. Oh, my word. Yeah, I thought we got rid of double entendre on this show. I
never.
Really did. I
We've
did
got a whole 3 hours to fill.
Yeah, it's just entendre, really. I mean, there's no double about it. Right, what do
so
we do then?
So anything about where we need to go?
No, not at the exact place. See, at the moment you're in Great Melton. So we've got to find out a place that combines, this is the interesting bit, combines the concerns of one Pertwee played. Of his concerns, if it was Wurzel Gummidge, he was concerned about losing his head. So combines the concerns of one Pertwee played. Head, if he was, is there something with head in the name?
You're not convinced by the Dad's Army? Bill Pertwee.
The only thing I can think of Dad's Army is Thetford. That's too far away for you to get to for the next clue. But you never know. It could have something to do with the Dad's Army reference.
But where's Graham gone now? Oh, OK. No, we don't need to know. Gone to buy a book. Oh, dearie me.
It's like a stream of consciousness from you, isn't it? It's a stream of consciousness from you, Julie, isn't it? The whole time.
Possibly. In life in general. Well, I might as well sit down.
Yeah, you take it easy.
It is so lovely today. Everyone's wearing their sun hats very sensibly.
Was this forecast for the weekend? I don't remember it being a good forecast
this
weekend.
Yes, it was. Yes, I said today, highs of 18 or 19 degrees Celsius. Sunday was the better of the 2 days. Monday, warmer still, possibly temperatures into the 70s. It was exactly what I said.
It's funny, you sound just like a weather presenter. Just like
I sounded very defensive. Yes, I did. I think you'll find. I think if you go back and look at the recording.
A defensive weather presenter, nothing worse. Right, 01603 617321. What do we do now? Where does Julie go from there? Where does she go from Great Melton? A place that perhaps combines the concerns of one Pertwee played. Similar to a swap shop, is Philip or Jason here? Give us a buzz. 01603 617321. Be good to get Julie moving after the news. 81333, start your text with the word Norfolk. Get on the Treasure Quest Facebook page and at BBC Norfolk on Twitter. Thanks for your help so far.
Norfolk News, Norfolk Life. This is BBC Radio Norfolk.
It's 10 o'clock, BBC Radio Norfolk, with the latest news. Here's Lucy Lightfoot.
Good morning. President Trump is to urge the leaders of 40 Muslim nations to join the fight against the threat from Islamist militants. Mr. Trump's on the second day of a visit to Saudi Arabia. Earlier this year, he was accused of inciting Islamophobia by his attempt to ban people from several Muslim-majority countries from travelling to the United States. Our security correspondent Frank Gardner is in Riyadh, where Mr. Trump will make his address.
Today is going to be a really tricky test for him. He's going to have to move very carefully in the way he delivers this very sensitive speech. You know, for any Western leader to come to a country like Saudi Arabia and address the leaders of more than 40 Muslim nations about Islam, their religion, this is sensitive stuff. But for Donald Trump, who tends to kind of go off script and shoot from the hip, this is very risky.
The New York Times is reporting that China killed or jailed at least 18 American intelligence sources between 2010 and 2012. The paper says what happened severely damaged US spying operations there for several years. Muslim students at the University of East Anglia are still uncertain where they can worship, with just days to go until Ramadan. They found out last week their prayer space is to close today, leaving many concerned they won't be able to properly observe the holy month. Well, the UEA says they have provided the multi-faith centre as a temporary alternative, but Aya Delphi from the Islamic Society says that's simply missing the point.
Ramadan really is a communal time where you spend time with your family, you spend time with your friends, and not having that kind of space on campus to really observe Ramadan is, I have no word for it really.
Australia's immigration minister has said more than 7,000 people who arrived in the country by boat will face deportation unless they can prove they are not fake refugees. Peter Dutton said those who were refusing or had failed to lodge formal claims would have until the 1st of October to prove that they need Australian protection. Older people in Great Yarmouth are to be offered a new social event at weekends. Contact the Elderly is a national charity which organises monthly tea parties for people on their own. The charity's planning to start the get-togethers in Yarmouth. Its new Eastern Counties Development Officer, Johnny Wood, lives in Cromer and wants to expand the charity work across the county.
Contact the Elderly has been running for over 50 years. We've actually got one existing group up in Burnham Market. My hope is to increase the profile of Contact the Elderly in Norfolk and make our services available to older guests who would like the opportunity to come out once a month, but also to volunteers who would like to get involved in something in the local community.
BBC Radio Norfolk News, it's now 10:03.
BBC Radio Norfolk weather.
Hello there, just a smattering of cloud today. It's well broken, so we'll get some decent spells of sunshine, and we're expecting a temperature this afternoon of 19 degrees in the centre of Norwich. No need for the brolly, the showers are gone, and the winds are much lighter, so a very pleasant Sunday. Overnight tonight, lots of clear skies once again, but not too chilly. I think we'll just about hold in double figures in the towns, and 8 or 9 degrees across the countryside. So we've got a dry, settled and very warm week ahead. Plenty of sunshine. Just a bit more cloud perhaps on Monday. Warm nights as well. We could be heading up towards the mid-20s at some points this week. Wendy Hurrell with your BBC Radio Norfolk weather.
Treasure Quest on BBC Radio Norfolk.
It is Treasure Quest this week with Julie Ranger and David Whiteley. And technical problems in the studio, but don't worry about that. It's okay, it's fine. We gloss over that one. Anyway, at the moment, we're in Great Melton, having solved Clue 1 very rapidly this morning, thanks to you. This is Clue 2. A place that perhaps combines the concerns of one Pertwee played, similar to a swap shop, is Philip or Jason here? So, multicoloured swap shop. Philip or Jason, Philip Schofield and Jason Donovan both played Joseph. It's Technicolor Dreamcoats, you've got the colours there. And John Pertwee played Wurzel Gummidge. There could be a Scarecrow Festival somewhere where one of the Scarecrows is wearing a multicoloured outfit. And that could be the one Judy's got to find to get the clue. Got a text here from Matt. Hi, Matt. Says, Warden Hodges. Now, that was played by Bill Pertwee in Dad's Army. Warden Hodges was always going on about turning the light off, so power may be Swaffham near the wind turbine.
Oh, right, hold on a minute.
Maybe
everyone
near the wind turbine.
Don't let my wife sue.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
I have no idea what's going on at the moment. Sounds like they're doing something there. All I heard Julie say was, everybody in, and a man say, don't let my wife see this. What on earth is going on? We leave Julie alone for 3 minutes, and something bizarre is going on. Would you like to explain? Exposition,
we were
please.
Just having a photograph taken.
Oh, I see.
And yes, we'll leave it there, shall we? I hope your wife wasn't listening. No.
That was so funny. Yeah. I literally said, are you in? Oh, don't let my wife see this. This is all we heard. So, okay.
This programme always does my reputation so much good.
I know it does. Right.
Are we going somewhere? Are we going to Windsor? Where are we going?
I was trying to talk to you. You were too busy doing publicity photos or something else.
Oh, dear. Oh. Then I nearly fell off the bench because Graham got off one end.
Have you had any E numbers yet?
No, all just right. Think what I was like.
I know. What Matt was saying is that Warden Hodges in Dad's Army was always going on about turning the lights off. So power, right. Maybe Swaffham near the wind turbine. Now, didn't you open that officially? Okay. I seem to remember.
Yes, I did.
Yeah, I've got a good memory, haven't I?
You have.
I seem to remember you did that on Look East about 400 years ago.
I did two. The one at Swaffham, yeah. The second one at Swaffham, I think it was, wasn't it? The second one at Swaffham, and then the one near Acton, I think, wasn't it? That's the one where I hollered to remember.
So if you've got a wind turbine that needs opening, that needs turning on, then just get Julie. Julie turns on the wind turbines of Norfolk. Okay, so where do we go now? Julie at the moment and Graham are stuck in Great Melton. I'm sure they're having a lovely time. Worst places to be stuck.
Hi, girls.
And Wurzel was always worried about his Aunt Sally from Carol. Hi, Carol. Aunt Sally.
Nice to meet you.
I don't know. We don't know what town we're supposed to be going to. Mary says Joseph is going to be on in Wyndham on July the 8th. But is that to do with Wurzel Gummidge? To do with the Scarecrow? Let's go through this again. A place that perhaps combines the concerns of one Pertwee played, similar to a swap shop, is Philip or Jason here? 01603 617321. Come on. We need to get Julie and driver Graham mobile again. Mobile. Mobile? Mobile. That's because I was in the States recently and they say mobile. You going mobile?
So bad.
Are you doing your own little program together and doing your own little thing? Because
we're just singing.
Having a lovely
time
together.
We wanted a bit of Jason's Technicolor Dreamcoat. We're a bit disappointed if we don't end up going to that.
We'll probably
more cakes are arriving.
Some.
Look at those. Oh, yum. Hello, ladies. They look gorgeous. What's in there?
Strawberry muffins.
Strawberry muffins. Oh, yum, yum. Oh, I'm getting it now. I'm starting getting a bit anxious. Now,
come on.
If we don't get Julie
and Graham going, then this is going to end up being a 3-hour advert for the Great Melton Fate. 01603 617321, a place that perhaps combines the concerns of one Pertwee played, similar to a swap shop. Is Philip or Jason here? Mary says Joseph is going to be on in Wyndham on July the 8th. And Shirley rang in to say that at Limelight Studios on Aylsham Road, they're doing Joseph.
Oh, are they?
When
is
you
that
say
in Wyndham?
Limelight Studios, I don't know where Limelight Studios are. Aylsham Road in what town? Maybe it's in the city. Oh, I don't know where that is. Where are Limelight Studios? Sounds like it's in Norwich, but I don't know for definite. Give us a buzz. 01603 617321. Is that what we should be doing? Should we be doing that? Is that where we're going? If it's going to be, if Limelight Studios is in Wyndham, then people are saying Wyndham for this, or do we go, is Aylsham Road, Limelight Studios, are they in Norwich?
Where's the Limelight Studio?
Aylsham Road, usually Norwich, isn't it? Yeah, OK, Ryan on Facebook says, aren't Limelight Studios on Aylsham Road doing Joseph next week? Right, OK, we're going to have to go to Aylsham Studios, I think.
Is that in Norwich?
Here we go. Got it, here we go. Hang on, I'll tell you why, Limelight. If Bill Pertwee, as Warden Hodges, was concerned about switching the lights out,
Get that light out.
Yeah, so you got Limelight. Yeah.
Oh!
Yeah.
Let's go.
Limelight Studios.
Good.
I think we'll go for that then. I think we're going to... Okay, brilliant. So we need to dish some of these out. Shirley, get one of these. And so does Ryan. Thank you very much, Ryan. Well done. Daniel on Facebook said, Bill Pertwee's character in Dad's Army was both the ARP warden and a greengrocer. So limes are green... Aren't they? There we go. Limes are green. So in the name and something connecting to the ARP, I think we've got it. Limelight Studios. So that's it. Limelight Studios, Aylsham Road. Betty is in Cossie. Betty, good morning.
Good morning.
We got there eventually.
Yeah, Aylsham Road is near where the old swimming pool was. As you go up to the main road to Cromer on that road, it's along the road. There was a school there. They shut the school down, and the lady I know, she opened it up as the Limelight.
Sorry, is it north of the city? Is it north of Norwich? North of the city, isn't it?
Well, it's...
on the Aylsham
Road. Helston Road, towards Helston.
Helston Road?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's up, as you come up on the ring road by the old Anglia Square, you go up to Aylsham Road.
at the Elsham Road there.
Yeah, and it's on the right-hand side. It's not far from the traffic lights there. And it's an old... It was a school, but the lady sold us. She took it over.
And she's turned it to Limelight Studios.
So there's a notice up outside.
And that says you come off the roundabout at Anglia Square, isn't it, as you were saying
there,
Betty?
Yeah, as you come up Anglia Square, you come up to Helston, and that's... I forget what it's called now.
Limelight Studios.
Yeah, that's it. Round, just past Anglia Square, and you go up to the...
So there's a pub, isn't there? There's a pub on the right.
Let's pub, but it's just past that.
Artichoke.
Just before that pub as you come up.
Okay, just before
it's
that.
It's easy to see it. It's on the main road.
I'm glad you're picturing it in your
and
head.
And they do show, because I used to be in one of their shows, what they did.
Oh, did you?
Yes,
what
I did.
What did you play?
Well, we were elderly ladies singing.
Ooh.
And there's a lot of children there, and they had to put shows on.
Do you want to give us a blast now?
Yeah,
can you sing us something now, Betty?
I'm not there at the moment.
No, can you sing us something? Can you sing me something now?
Oh.
Go on.
You raise me up. I have sang to you.
That'll do. I'll tell you what, though, Betty, for your trouble, have one of these. And thank you very much. It's lovely to hear from you.
It's easy to see. And a lot of children, they're in the shows. And the people at Dereham, they help out sometimes with the shows, which they do shows at Dereham.
That's great. Betty, thank you very much. Betty and Cossie. Did you hear all that then, Julie? No, she didn't. OK, they're in a black spot. Nicola on Facebook. Morning, Nicola. She says, Limelight Studios, Aylsham Road. My son is in it, in the production. He's playing Benjamin. Fantastic, Nicola. Thanks for getting in touch. Right then, so we're now going to head to Limelight Studios on Aylsham Road in Norwich. So back into Norwich, but I imagine they're going to have to get to the north of the city. So,
oh, hello.
I think the way they're coming is going to be different.
Oh,
you can hear me. You can hear me. Did you get
now,
any
listen,
of that?
Where? No. So, I
Saints preserve us.
Square.
You got that bit.
Hold on, you've gone again.
No, okay.
Hold on, no. Come in and go.
Yeah, I'm coming and going.
No, I hit you. Right, so, we need... Is it near the Artichoke?
Yes, it is. Yeah, that's the pub I was thinking of. I think it's on that road. I think that's what Betty was saying, and that's the road that... The Aylsham Road.
Oh,
and,
so, if
and
we're if... going out of the city with the on the right, where is it in relation to that?
Sorry, say that again. You
right.
Dropped out again then.
We're going out of the city,
yeah,
with the Artichoke pub on the right. Where is...
Well, because you're going to come through Anglia Square. It's a one-way street, isn't it? So buses come one way, but
okay,
you're coming up there. You'll come to that junction, the traffic lights, and you'll go over the traffic lights. So you're heading in a northerly direction toward, as if you're going towards Aylsham. So then, I'm not sure.
So Artichoke's on the right.
Yeah. So keep it on your right and stay on that road. And
where then is...
It's not far from there, apparently. It's got a big sign. It used to be a school, so a building that looks like an old school would be Limelight Studios.
Oh, it's an old school, Graham. So pass the Artichoke pub on the right, keep going, and there's an old school...
And Diana has texted in. Morning, Diana. She says, it's next to the big bike shop. And I think I can picture the bike shop on Aylsham Road. Though the switchboard is full now, with people probably saying, no, that's not the way to go. This is the way you want to go. So maybe someone's coming on with some better directions. We live in hope. Though I think Betty's were pretty good. We're getting a call through now. It's going to give us some directions, but I'm not sure if Julie can hear us. Sharon, it's our friend Sharon in Taverham. Morning, Sharon.
Morning.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good?
According to the web, the Limelight Studios are on Aylsham Road.
Mm-hmm.
The Artichoke is on Maglan Road.
Oh, yeah, of course it is. Yeah, but it isn't on that junction.
No, okay. No.
Okay.
Whereabouts is Julie at the moment?
Well, your guess is as good as mine. She's back on the microphone. Julie, do you want to talk to Sharon? Because the Artichoke is on Magdalen Road. I was getting confused.
Oh, no. Morning.
Morning.
Are we on the wrong road?
You are. Whereabouts exactly are you at the moment?
Oh, we're still now. We're not even into Norwich yet. We've just got onto the main road, having left Great Moulton. So, what is it, the B1?
1108?
Yeah, I imagine it's that one, yeah.
Right. So...
That's going to bring them over the top of Norwich anyway, isn't it? So if they
yeah,
get to the Ring Road,
come to the Ring
they don't
Road.
Need to go through Anglia Square, do they?
No. I'm just having a quick look. If you go straight round, you can go straight round the Ring Road and then come down the Aylsham Road.
It's not a bad idea, is it? So they'll pick up the A140 as they come in.
Yeah, and actually come the Aylsham Road that way.
and then just come down the Elsham Road until we meet for the Philadelphia Lane.
That's a good idea. So if they they pick up the A140 Ring Road, and then they're going to come back down.
Pick up the A140 Ring Road. Hold on. Hello, David.
It would help if they could hear us. Yeah, go on.
David, we're just about to literally hit. Did I just hear we need to get onto the ring road?
Yeah, I think. Yeah, I think what Sharon.
Which
said,
way?
Is it headed towards Cromer?
Going towards Well, so what do we need to do? Go towards the direction of Great Yarmouth on the A47. Is that what you're saying? Get onto the A47.
No, the A140.
Get onto the A140.
Yeah, the ring road. You need to be on the outer ring road.
Oh, okay.
Are we going on the inner ring road or the outer ring road?
The ring road. We were just passing the outer ring road, so we got all confused.
No, you could. What we were saying is you could do the outer ring road, then come in that way, but actually go to the inner ring road. Because
I think it'd be quicker, wouldn't it, if we go to the inner ring road?
Go to the inner ring road.
Okay, coming into Colney. I think we make a top B.
I think we're great. I think we're doing well. Sharon, so if they do the inner ring road, can you give them directions with the inner ring road?
Yes, so from the inner ring road, they need to head towards the inner ring road. Yeah, you get to the inner ring road, head towards the flyover. Don't go over the flyover, but go left up St Augustine's that way.
So about where the Hollywood Cinema is.
Yeah. Don't go into Anglia Square. Or don't go over the flyover. But if you take the Elsham Road.
Is that the roundabout where there's the framing shop?
Yes.
And the men's shed.
Yes.
That's it. So they're coming off there.
Yeah.
I can picture it now.
So we need to come off. You know where the framing shop is, and there's some.
And you're going to go past Professional Music Technology, and then there's like a little.
There's a guitar shop.
That's how I know it.
Something or others. St Augustine's.
Yes, that's it. I think that's.
St Augustine's? Yeah. Is that where we go, David?
So you want to get to the ring. So when you get to the ring road, right? So I can talk you in from the ring road. So say you're going to come. So say you're going to pick up the ring road. Well, I don't know which way. I'm trying to work out which way you're coming in, but I'm trying to think. If you're on the inner ring road,
we're just passing the hospital on the right.
Okay. Yeah. You want to on the right? On the right. Okay. You're coming that way.
The other private hospital is on the left.
All right. Okay.
And we're going past the Norwich Research Park on the right at the moment.
Well, you want to get to the ring road, the part of it that picks up where the car dealers.
I know where we're going.
Yeah, you do.
I know where we're going.
You do know.
It's fine.
Do you?
I know.
Do you?
Well, I know how to get to the roundabout. Out, but then after that, I'm confused because I didn't hear it, all the rest of it, as to where this place actually is.
Sharon, are you still with us? Can you talk them on that? Because Julie knows how to get to that road allegedly. So if you can then talk.
Allegedly. What are you saying about my sense of direction?
It's about as good as mine, right? Sharon, can you just yes, Julie, go on?
Yes. So Julie, once you get from St Augustine's, yeah, is that where you're talking from? You want to know the instructions for?
Yeah, so we'll turn left as if we're heading up the A140.
Yes. Yep.
And where is it in relation to that?
Right, you go up St Augustine's, past...
St Augustine's, fine.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to go down Dereham Road and round the inner ring road.
Okay, lovely. So, sorry, then we go up St Augustine's, and where is it in relation to...
Go past St Luke's Church.
Past St Luke's Church.
Past the boarded up pub, the Edwards whatever.
Is these on the right or the left?
They're on the
past
right.
Boarded up. On right.
It's the top of Pengrove, and there's a cycle shop.
And then there's the cycle shop.
And then it's just past there on the right.
And then it's just past the cycle shop on the right. Okay, lovely. Thank you so much.
Okay.
You've been brilliant, Sharon. Thank you so much. I'm going to give you one of these. Thank you so much, Sharon, for being so patient as well as the signal dipped in and out. Julie, does that all make sense to you?
Yes, and Graham, you're nodding, aren't you, with...
St Augustine.
Okay,
yeah,
all right.
We know where we're going. We know the cycle shop. Is that the cycle shop you were talking about?
Maybe.
Possibly.
Other cycle shops are available.
Yay.
but they might not be as good. All right, okay. Well,
how are we doing for time?
We're all right. 20 past 10. 20 past 10.
Okay. No, right. Stay positive.
I'm going to come back to you in a minute. Have a little tune. Everyone can breathe easy now. Have a little rest. Have a little relax. Because I think you're a few minutes away yet. Sharon, thank you for your directions this morning. 20 past 10, it is Treasure Quest with Julie Ranger and David Whiteley here on BBC Radio Norfolk. It's Genesis, Follow You, Follow Me. How apt. Genesis, Follow You, Follow Me, 25 past 10. It is Treasure Quest on BBC Radio Norfolk, this and every Sunday here on BBC Radio Norfolk. And this week we've got Julie, who's doing the running for us.
Here.
Hello?
Yeah, I did. Hello.
Hello, all right.
Hi. Hello.
Sorry to interrupt. Hi. I'm sorry to interrupt your conversation.
That's all right. No, Graham and I are just discovering that we used to live quite near each other.
Oh, I didn't know that, Julie.
Yeah. So there you go.
Wow.
Another bit of useless information.
Another fascinating
to fill your Sunday morning. Oh, dear.
Right, wrong clue two.
Right.
A place that perhaps combines the concerns of one Pertwee played, similar to a swap shop. Tell him to shut up a minute. Is Philip or Jackson?
Sorry, he says we've got to stop talking.
I used to live down there.
Did you? We really did live very close
They're
to
in a world
other.
Of their own, aren't they, Questmaster, today? They're in a world of their own.
Oh, I am sorry. We've been very rude, David. I just didn't know Tales of the Unexpected was filmed here.
Yeah, it was.
And in that pub that isn't there anymore.
The pub's gone. Yeah. Where? Oh, OK. Sorry, do continue.
No, I mean, you let me know when you want me to read the clue out again.
Now.
Is that all right?
Now.
Is there a break?
Yes.
Is there a break in your transmission that I can now...
Well, we think it's quite novel. We can actually hear you.
Not everyone would agree with you on that one.
No, come.
A place that perhaps combines the concerns of one Pertwee played. Similar to a swap shop is Philip or Jason here. Right, we're off to Limelight Studios. A place that perhaps combines the concerns of one Pertwee played. He played Warden Hodges in... Bill Pertwee played Warden Hodges in Dad's Army. And he was always concerned about the lights being put out. So light is part of the clue. And Daniel on Facebook says he was a greengrocer as well. So maybe a place with green. So lime is green. So Limelight Studios we're heading for. Similar to a swap shop. Is Philip or Jason here? So he had a multicoloured swap shop and Joseph's Technicolour dream coat. Because Philip Schofield, Jason Donovan both played Joseph in the amazing Technicolour dream coat. So apparently Limelight Studios are putting on Joseph. Right, you can carry on now.
Do I need to find Joseph and his coat, do you think? In the coat?
Yeah, I reckon you might have
in
to.
In the coat pocket.
Nicola on Facebook says that her son is in it. He's playing Benjamin. So he'll be there rehearsing.
Brilliant. Mm-hmm. Oh, good. We need a bit of singing.
You can join in.
Not from us.
You can do it.
No, I love Joseph. I was in it when I was about 8.
Were you? What part did you play? Or were you just a...
Oh, I can't remember.
A West End Wendy.
You know. West End Wendy. Now. Let's not go there. Oh, yeah. What do you think they'll be singing?
I close my eyes. Drew back the curtain, to see for certain what I thought I knew far, far away.
Well, we could do the whole lot, but I think we should...
Let them do it.
More of this and... very quickly.
Okay.
Oh, God, I've got a bit of a sinking feeling. I don't like it when I get this halfway through.
Well, I know, because it's 10:30 now, you see.
I know. No, Jules.
Come on.
Stay positive.
It'd be good if you could get there pretty quickly from now. It'd be good if we could, you know. I hope the limiter is on.
Oh, look, this is where I lived. I used to live here. There we go.
Probably have the same doctors.
Well, did you use the laundrette?
Oh, all the time.
Oh, me too. The lovely ladies in the laundrette, aren't they brilliant? I've been there for years. Good. They were a fab team. Sorry, we digress.
It's fine.
So, we're just about to go on to Ham Street. And then are we going to cut through?
Little cut through.
You'll get brownie points for saying it Ham Street, I tell you. You'll get lots of brownie points for that.
I know. Did you notice how I slipped that in?
Yeah, I was very impressed.
I'm a proper local now. Only been here. How many years? 40. 1999. What? Hey, cheeky. Hey, yeah, Graham, am I allowed? Graham had a special birthday.
No,
I didn't know. I feel bad.
No, don't feel bad.
And I was going to...
I don't even know you had birthdays, so I never remember yours.
So I should have really bought you a cake.
No. I'm sure we'll go to... There'll be more cakes
later. Those strawberry buns look very nice. Well, anyway, belated happy birthday. Okay, so we're just about to do the cheeky cut through. Turning left. I hardly ever come this way anymore. New lighting shop. Well, it's not very new, is it? It's probably been there 100 years. I don't know whether you can still hear us.
We can.
No, are you just listening to our podcast?
No, I am.
I dare interrupt.
Are
we not?
I daren't interrupt the little conversations they're having this morning.
Really? Oh dear. Oh right. We should be there in about 5 minutes, shouldn't we?
5 minutes.
What music have we got coming out? I've never ever had a request ever on the radio.
Oh, look
if we
out.
Get the treasure, can I have a request?
Yeah, well, that's not looking likely.
Could you
moment.
Put on your best DJ voice and give me a shout
babe.
Out?
Not off. We've got a shout out here for Julie Arranger. She's the runner today on Treasure Quest. She got a request
runner.
On a Treasure Quest. So what would you like to hear then, Jules? Uh-huh.
That's just so good.
Uh-huh.
It's so bad.
Uh-huh.
And use the word runner very loosely. Oh, we're cutting through Oak Street. We'll cut the corner off. Right, what tune would I have? Now there's, gosh, now I'm going to have some time to think about this. If I had one tune to play. Something quite lively.
I thought you thought about this. I thought you actually had an idea as to what song you wanted.
No, I haven't at all.
Oh.
No idea. Can I?
If you want.
Can I choose something?
If you want to.
Does it have to be off our Radio Norfolk playlist?
I'll try and find it.
That's coming up.
No.
Can I have just...
I'll see where...
Really? It's the boss listening. He'll be like, Princess Jules is on the show, trashing everything as usual.
Do what you like.
Issues,
I don't mind.
Demands.
Do what you like.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, do your worst.
Well done. Men in green jackets. Hello, boys. Oh, right. What if, Graham, if you were going to have a tune, what would it be?
No, don't ask him.
Chubby, cheap, cheap, middle of the road.
No, it's your choice. Don't ask what other one is. I hate that. It's like when you go to a restaurant with someone, they go, what are you having? Well, what are you having?
Oh, I don't know. There's just so many options. I really don't. God, I really right. can't. Please, oh. have. Can I, if, is this going to actually happen?
Yeah.
Oh, Elsham great. Road. Right, we're on the Elsham Road.
Right, OK. Get back to the job in hand. Worry about your request later, and let's try and find Limelight Studios.
Boarded up pub on the right.
Yep, that's the pub that.
That's boarded up pub.
Sharon
there
was talking
it is.
About.
Is that the boarded no, up
that's
pub?
An, oh, that's the boarded up. Boarded up
okay,
pub.
Cycle shop.
Cycle shop coming up on the right.
So Limelight Studios right? is imminent.
A little way up.
And then it'll just be past it. This hurrah!
Is the area,
hurrah!
Miller Dance School area, isn't it?
Is yeah. it?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, there's a cycle shop.
Cycle shop.
Limelight! Yay! In there! Oh, hold on! Oh, stop! Oh, they do baby yoga. Okay, we're just waiting to get over the road through the very tight gateway. Oh, well negotiated.
Well done.
Done.
I'm going down the back. Who
are
knows?
We? How do we
who
get
knows?
In?
Well, yeah, exactly.
Aren't we supposed to be going there? Oh, that's so tight. We're not going to get through, are we? Oh, breathe in.
Looking for a door.
There's a door that's open. Oh, hold on.
Does it say Limelight Studios over the door?
I was going to do a Yui.
No, hold on a minute. It says Crystal Beauty something or other on this back door. Do you think we need to go back around the front?
Let's go back around the front. I've got to do a Yui.
Yeah, we're just turning. It's a lovely building. Old school building. Okay. And main entrance. Look, I can see a coat! I can see a coat!
Is it amazing? And
it is! It is! It is! Oh, heck, hold on! Whoops! Forgot. There we go.
She's away.
Safety belt off, microphone, adjust headset. Okay, can I hear? I can't hear you at the moment.
It's okay, I'm talking now. I am here.
Shut the door.
I thought I might join in.
At the moment. Do you want to check my. Am I turned on? Oh, can't hear anything.
I'm here, don't worry.
No.
I'm still here. I'm still in the studio.
It
sounds like they're there. They've had a jolly time getting
here. We can't hear you,
okay,
so
well,
I'm
I can
just
hear
going
you.
To carry on.
Well, just like you have been all morning.
You can hear me. Oh, no, hold on.
I can hear you.
Hold on.
Can you hear me now?
There we are. There we are.
Good. You got me now.
Aha.
Good.
Oh, hey,
you didn't hear what I was saying about you, did you?
No.
Right, go on then. Get in there, kid. Get in there.
In through the door. Hello. Hi. And hi. That's a very nice coat you have there.
Why, thank you very much.
It's very multicoloured and technical. Would it be all right if I had a little look at it?
Technical?
I don't know if it'll be that.
It's very technical. It's got wires.
It's got lights on it.
Headphones that you can hear through. Well, there's nothing here. Okay.
Hold on a second.
Hold on.
We've got a bit of a problem.
Oh.
As you can probably hear just about, we're having a rehearsal today, but we're one cast member short.
Oh, no. Really?
Yeah.
Really?
So I heard that you love Joseph. Is that right?
Yeah.
So can you remember all the colours?
No.
You couldn't remember some of them?
No, I can't remember any
right.
of them.
Well, I'm afraid... I'm
it was red and yellow and green
yeah,
and
right.
purple and something or other.
So I'm going to have to pull you in, if that's okay.
Okay. Come David, did you know about this?
No, I didn't, but I'm loving
Master,
it.
I'm going to kill you.
Come on in. Can I put this coat on you?
Thank you very much. Coat's on.
Are you wearing the coat? Are you
yeah,
wearing the coat?
Look
on
the mirror, you can see the colours.
Oh!
Oh. Okay, we're back.
Here we go.
Best voice, Julie, best voice.
Is it out? No, not yet. Not yet. There's a huge mirror, and thankfully, the colours are printed on it. Yes.
Did she unplug it so we didn't have to hear her singing? Come on, we need to get the clue.
Well, I can't stop.
Tell us to speed it up.
Can I? No, we can't. They're good. Yellow and green and brown and scarlet and black and ochre and peach and ruby and olive and... No, oh, whoops. No, not that bit. When do I do... Oh, well, there's a lady giving me directions. She's going to tell me. Oh, it's coming up. She's giving me the thumbs up. Oh, I'm being pointed at. Me. Ruby, olive, violet, fawn, lilac, gold, chocolate, mauve, cream, crimson, silver, rose, azure, lemon. Oh. We're gonna get there in the end. I'm gonna have
come on.
Pink, orange, and
yay!
Yay! Well done, everyone.
Julie. I expect you'll be getting a call back on this one.
I don't think so. Do I get a part, everyone? Listen to that. Resounding vote of confidence, for goodness sake.
Can we have the clue now? Has she done it?
Yeah,
can
where's the clue? Oh, no, you're not going to make me look for it. I've sang for it. Okay, who's got the clue? Where's... Can I... You've got a very snazzy jacket too. Can I have a look at your jacket? A closer look? I'm looking at Joseph's very nice multicoloured jacket. Nothing there. I'm frisking you. That's really probably... Is the clue on you? Is the clue... Oh, look. I'm not going to say where that clue is. It's stapled to you. It's actually pinned to your backside. There we go.
Sounds painful.
I know. I'm trying
to...
You got it.
Is it in your hand?
No, wait. We have... We are unpinning in my hand. Clue three!
Oh, my word.
Good work, everybody. We got it.
Oh.
Right, well, mate, I am going to read
go for
this
it, quickly.
Clue now.
Quick.
Now.
You've got any puff
you
left?
You're all fantastic. Thank you so much. Oh, dear. Clue three. Oh, dear. It's one of these. It's no, that is the clue. That's not me saying that. So, oh, dear. It's one of these. Is it an argument or a line? Keep calm and search for signs of a game you've played before.
An argument keep or a line is probably a row or a row.
Okay.
Argument
oh,
or a...
dear. These. Is it an argument or a line?
Signal's going a bit now. Questmaster.
Yes. And search for signs of a game you've played before.
Well, we're losing the signal to you, so, Julie. But
you, is this a game I've played before, like football? I've played football. What else have I played?
No, I was going to say, actually...
Side everyone, because they can't hear me in here. Can I just say, you were brilliant. Can I have a huge round of applause for yourself?
Well done, well done. Right.
Excellent.
We're going to go through clue two, Questmaster.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
A place that perhaps combines the concerns of one Pertwee played, similar to a swap shop, is Philip or Jason here?
Yeah, Bill Pertwee played Warden Hodges in Dad's Army, and he was a greengrocer and the ARP warden, so he might be concerned with lime and light.
Ah, so, limelight. Lime, of course, lime. Yes,
yeah.
The concerns of... Yeah, sorry. Similar to a swap shop.
Multicoloured swap shop.
Is Philip or Jason here?
Yeah, if you were a kid in the early 90s like me, you'll remember very much in the news was Jason Donovan and Philip Schofield were the two leads in Joseph, one after the other. And yes, there you go. And or is Julie referred to his jacket there, so it's Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Jacket.
Jacket, which also called a technical jacket,
yes,
as
technical
well.
Jacket. There's clue three. And I should say that, yes, when I wrote this clue, I completely forgot about the fact that it wasn't Sophie doing it.
So it's something that Sophie's done before, yeah, perhaps,
in
the last one. Okay, well, don't worry. You're very good. I liked the last one very much. It goes down in one of my favourite clues so far on the show. I've got to keep him happy. Clue three. Oh, dear, it's one of these. Is it an argument or a line? Well, I think that's a row, because you could have a row or a line could be a row, potentially. So what do you think? Keep calm and search for signs of a game you've played before. But this isn't a game you've played before, Julie. It's a game that Sophie's played before. So unless you've listened to every treasure...
Sophie played.
Every Sunday. Well, I hope you've been taking notes.
The game that Sophie's have played.
Every weekend, every Sunday, you should have been listening. We're going to go to the travel and then we're going to come back to you. And I think we've found out a lot about the performance there, but we'll find out a bit more in a minute. Just gone 20 to 11.
BBC Radio Norfolk Travel.
And here's Howard. Hi, Howard.
Hiya, well, firstly, the main route's all still looking fine this morning. There's no delays heading across the A47 or the A12 as well. In Setchi, there are roadworks and temporary lights on the main road in both directions at Setch Road. In Stiffkey, also works on Wells Road at Greenway. And in Great Plumstead, Middle Road shut today for works as well. That's to construct a new bridge. And as for trains, there's no delays running across East Midlands or Greater Anglia, just into and out of Norwich. So that's all moving fine so far this morning. And today, all day, the Norwich and Norfolk Festival continues. So that will be in the city centre. Now, if you see anything or can update me, call 01603 617 321. I'm Howard Kassam with your BBC Radio Norfolk Travel.
Treasure Quest on BBC Radio Norfolk.
Okay, we are coming up to 10:45. Got an hour and 12 minutes-ish before we have to have the treasure in Julie's mitts. I'm laughing because the Questmaster and El Grana are dancing along to this funky tune. It was like a little rhythm. It's good, I like that. Is that your routine, is it? Is it stopped by the Spice Girls? Is this track stopped by the Spice Girls? It sounds like it. Okay, friend. Clue three. Oh, dear, it's one of these. Is it an argument or a line? Well, I think that could be a row, as in a row or a row. An argument is a row or a line is a row. So something row, maybe? Keep calm and search for signs of a game you've played before. But this is a game that Sophie's played before because the QM forgot that it was Julie on today. How could you forget that it was you? How could you forget that it was you, Julie?
Oh, I know. After that performance, unforgettable.
Were you?
Jeez, deafened half of Norfolk.
I was very impressed with that. It was a lovely rendition. And I never knew.
Oh, do be quiet. Stop it.
I never knew there were so many colours in the world. And actually, I was thinking, for goodness sake, can we get through this to get the blinking clue?
You were not, were you?
I was. I was thinking that. Well, look, before we find out what's going on there a bit more, let's chat to Peter in Dursingham. Peter, good morning, sir.
Hello there. I just remember when Sophie kicked a rugby ball.
Oh, yes.
And I wondered, I can't remember what was in the clue, but I thought there might be different parts of the game, you know, line-ups and things like that. Does it fit with something from the rugby game?
Well, let's read the whole clue again. Oh, dear, it's one of these. Is it an argument or a line? Oh, I think that could be row, something row, you see.
Yeah, a line-up, you know, or row, lining up to do something in the game, maybe.
Keep calm and search for signs of a game you've played before. Peter, it might help. Thanks very much for your call this morning. I think we'd better give Peter one of these, actually, because she did play rugby, didn't she? She did play rugby, I remember that, and she did really well. And she had to kick the ball, didn't she? So do you want to find out a bit more about the production there while we kind of have a think about clue three? 01603 617321 is the number to call to get Julie away from Limelight Studios, though I think she may be, may have her eyes on an understudy part, perhaps.
Perhaps not. But we've got a Treasure Quest connection because Sarah, who stood next to me, is actually going to say...
David Clayton's niece.
Oh!
There you go.
I say.
I know, it's exciting. We suddenly realised we've met quite a few times before, but as I was throwing on my technicoloured coat, I didn't quite put two and two together. And it was lovely to see you.
And you, Julie.
So when is your performance?
Our performance is on the 31st of May to the 3rd of June at the Madden Market Theatre, 7:30. Saturday matinee, and there's still tickets available, and these kids, they're fabulous. They really, really need to fill that auditorium and show them some support. So if anyone wants any tickets, you can...
And is this a group that meets regularly?
This is Limelight Theatre Company, and we put on annual productions. Where You Are is Limelight Studios, and we hold regular classes here, weekly drama, singing...
Can anyone join?
Anyone, even you, yes.
Really?
Yes.
Well, I might spare you that.
Yeah. We've got a cast of 40 plus from the ages of 4 to, I think, 18.
Oh, that's brilliant.
Yeah.
Is 18 the cut-off? I mean, were you being very kind to me?
No, for this production, because it's a youth production.
Okay. Okay, but you have older members.
We do have older members.
Look, Graham's like, do be quiet. Even as old as you, Graham, now you celebrate your birthday.
That would be too high.
Oh, dear. Oh, well, yeah, we need to sell these tickets, don't we? Because the kids are brilliant. Absolutely fantastic. And, right, I think...
Julie. As much as you look young for your age, I doubt you're going to pass as 18, I'm afraid.
Do you not think so?
No.
I'm gutted. Yeah, really?
Maybe a couple of years ago you could have done, pastor that. But Tony's in Sheringham. Morning, Tony.
Morning, how are you?
Good, mate. How are you?
Yeah, great, thanks.
What can you do for us, buddy?
Right, I think you could be going to Sproston.
Go on, then.
Oh, dear, it's one of those again. You know, the pronunciation.
Oh, I see, yes.
And R-O-W, you've got in the middle there. Row or row, whatever you wish.
Oh, yeah.
And there's, you know, there's the schools around there. There's a tennis court, playing fields, whatever. So bowling greens. So that's in the rough area.
So you got it. Okay. So is it an argument or lie? So you think the row in the middle?
Yeah.
So yeah. So spruced. So how are we going to pronounce it today?
Well, it's Sproston or Sproston, isn't it?
Sproston. You say potato, I say potato. Let's call
exactly.
The whole thing off.
Say goodbye.
So Tony, thank you very much. I'm going to give you one of these.
Oh, lovely.
I think that could be. Unless anyone has any other ideas about that. I think that as you say, oh dear, it's one of these where we always kind of think, oh, how do we pronounce it? Questmaster, hello.
Yes, hello. I just thought I'd let you know that the photo gallery is going up as we go along today. Graham's sending the pictures back.
Great.
So I'm putting them.
Oh,
the
they're
gallery.
Not. Graham, have you been tweeting photos?
No,
you
sending them back so I can put them up at bbc.co.uk/treasurequest. And I'm just about to put up the ones from Joseph. And I thought I'd let you try and describe to the listeners, David. They can see it at bbc.co.uk/treasurequest. Would you like to try and describe this to the listeners?
What have you got? What have you got?
Right.
Just, I'm going to say goodbye to everyone. Bye, everyone. Take care. Right, Graham Barnard, you're in big trouble.
Okay, listen.
Everybody. Lovely to see you. What is it?
Later.
See you.
I'll try.
I want to know.
Let me describe
what.
It.
Let me see your phone. I want to
see.
Honestly.
Right, let me just describe
I
it
we were friends.
You. Let me just describe this.
Yeah, go on.
Okay, let me describe
Which one
it. Okay, just be quiet a minute. It's hard to get a word in. Right. Now I know how everyone feels with me. Right, OK. So Julie's got the coat on, the Technicolor coat on, with her little furry boots on. And, well, it looks like you're really singing. I mean, you're really singing, but so much so that you're...
I was... Oh, for goodness sake!
Your mouth...
That is the worst!
It's that one, then.
You... Look, we had an agreement that you were not to send in any horrible photographs.
Well, it's not horrible. It's not
right
horrible. It's mid-flow.
Anyway, I'll go and put that up now. bbc.co.uk/treasurequest. The gallery's the first couple already up.
I am
up.
Never
I'll go
doing
and
this
programme
ever again.
Oh, no, I don't believe it, Julie. We love you doing the programme. We love you doing the programme. It's a great shot. I mean, this in one picture could sum up what goes on Treasure Quest on a Sunday morning. On BBC Radio Norfolk. That is it. That is it
in
one
car.
Photo.
Come on, we're going to Sproston.
Well, you think, you hope
Sproston.
So.
I'm going to keep my mouth shut. From
I don't believe it. Ray, King's Lynn, morning, Ray. Save us.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
If I go to Sproston,
yep.
There's Sproston Sports and Social Club on Blue Ball Lane.
Sports and Social Club.
Yeah, they've got a charity fun day on.
Oh, a charity fun day. And maybe
so
they're doing
something to do with kicking rugby football.
Yeah, that. Oh, that's well. Do you know what, mate? I think that's probably the one. So that's on Blue Ball Lane.
Yeah, Blue Ball Lane.
Yeah, I know it. Okay, brilliant. Well, we'll get them there. Ray, thank you very much.
Okay.
All right, mate. Take care. Bye bye. Did you hear that then?
Yes. I'm still getting over the photograph.
No, you're not.
For
you
goodness'
it.
Sake.
Come on,
Graham.
A great picture. So you're off to Sproston.
So sorry. Where are we going in Sproston?
You're going to go to the Sports and Social Club, says Ray in Kings Lynn. Where
do you know where the Sports and Social Club is, Graham?
On Blue Ball Lane.
Right. Okay. What? Blue Ball Lane?
Blue Ball.
Do you know where it is? Yeah. So do we know where it is on Blue Ball?
Is it near Tesco's?
Is it near a supermarket beginning with T?
Yes, ending in Esco's.
Care must be taken.
All right, Viv. That's Viv. Right, OK, then. So you're going to head to Spruston. You know where it is when you
and then there's,
Blue
did
Ball
you
Lane.
Say there was some kind of sports event on?
Yeah, it's the Sport and Social Club in Spruston has a charity fun day today. And we think, because Sophie, this clue is referring to Sophie, keep calm and search for signs of a game you've played before. So probably rugby. Probably rugby.
But I'm
sure you'll do a fantastic job, Julie, having sung in the production of Joseph and his technical jacket.
Yeah, that's one of my most priceless moments. Get what, darling?
Seatbelt.
Hold on.
Get
your seatbelt on. Right, okay. Are you away?
Yeah.
You're away. Right, I'm gonna let you go. Off you go. Off you go. Goodbye. Catch you in a minute. It's Katy Perry. Katy Perry, Raw. Five to 11, Treasure Quest on BBC Radio Norfolk with Julie Ranger and David Whiteley. Sophie's got a week off this week, so Julie's on the road for us. We've got an hour before we have to have the treasure in Julie's grubby mitts. And, well, we're hopeful. We live in hope, don't we, Julie?
My grubby mitts?
Yeah.
Nothing grubby about my mitts. Well, slightly, because I was doing a little bit of gardening yesterday.
Well, there we go then. You've got potatoes under your fingernails. This is clue three. Oh dear, it's one of these. It's an argument or a line. So off to Sproust. Keep calm and search for signs of a game you've played before. Now, this is a game that Sophie's played before, because the Questmaster had forgotten that it was you today. We didn't forgotten, but I think you'd written it with Sophie in mind. But we think the game we're going to be playing is Rugger.
Can you say Rugger? Are you allowed to say Rugger?
Rugby. What's wrong with saying Rugger?
I know, but you don't say Rugger, do you?
I don't know. Why can't you say Rugger?
It's not the done thing, is it, to say Rugger?
I don't think it's all right.
What's wrong with that?
You're talking about rugby.
Yeah.
I didn't know.
It's not rhyming slang.
Yeah.
What are you trying to say, Graham? What are you trying to say? No, it's just Rugger.
Okay, so we are crossing the ring road.
Okay.
Yeah, we're coming on.
And then...
We're just about to hit Wroxham Road.
We are. Oh, whoops. Sorry.
And you're confident that you know where Blue Boar Lane is? You're confident you know where that is?
Graham is saying, are you confident you know where we're going? He's just concentrating at the moment. Hold on.
I'm David, by the way,
very
not Graham.
Busy.
I'm David.
No, I'm talking to Graham.
Graham is asking. You
oh,
said,
don't block the roundabout.
Yeah, come on. Out of the way. It's a treasure quest emergency.
We're on a mission. Two clues and an hour to go.
Don't say
we
that.
Can still do it. Yeah, we'll be in, out. We'll find the rugby-related clue.
I think you might I think you might have to do a bit of, you know, when you have to kick the rugby ball, you have to make a conversion, maybe, and kick it between the posts.
Oh, that'd be good. Yeah. Not because I was so good at rugby.
Well, I mean, if this
I played
picture,
a bit of American football for a while.
It's not the same thing, is it?
No, I know, but
you played it. You played it as a hobby.
Well, they taught it for a while at school because we had an American base near us, so the guys from the base came and taught us American football. I still, to this day, don't understand it.
No, well, it goes on for about 4 days,
fun.
Doesn't it? Each match goes on for about 4 days.
And they
days.
Were very big. Yeah. These guys were enormous and slightly frightening when they're running towards you.
Oh, what, so they put you in the middle with your shoulder pads on?
Yes,
and your
basically.
Helmet. Off you go. Off you go, Julie. There's the ball. Bye.
So, yeah, and I can't remember. Oh, yeah, they taught us baseball as well.
Now, baseball, that's a great game. Baseball, yeah, I like baseball.
Yeah, but you have to play rounders, really, don't you?
Rounders. In the UK. In Britain, we play rounders. Well, if this picture of you singing is anything to go by, I'm looking forward to seeing the picture of you playing rugby, if that is indeed
Stop
what you have to do.
Stop talking about the picture. Stop talking about the photograph. Graham and I used to have a beautiful friendship, which has now been well and truly tested.
Purely professional now.
It's evaporated.
Oh, we were trying to remember when we last worked together, and we're talking about car boot sales. We actually did a whole show from a car boot sale, didn't we, with Karen Buchanan?
No, Karen was off that day. You were Karen, and I was me, and it was Bradenham.
Oh, I thought Karen was there as well.
I think you and I co-presented.
Goodness me, we're talking about back in the dark ages, aren't we? Anyway, we're coming up to 11 o'clock, so I don't think we're going to get there before 11. Questmaster, yes, sir.
Well, I was going to say, after the car boot sale, Graham presented Julie's first ever go at TQ when you were waving at the ambulances at the QEH, Julie.
Do you remember that?
Oh, hold on a minute. I only caught that. Did you say that Graham stood in for me?
No, Graham did your first ever TQ, the first ever one you ever did, when you waved at the ambulances at the QEH.
Ah, you did the first treasure quest with me, ever. And I waved at the ambulances. Can you remember?
Oh, yes.
It was that memorable.
They can't remember at all. It is Treasure Quest here on BBC Radio Norfolk, where we're kind of reminiscing as well. We always like a bit of nostalgia. This is clue three. Oh, dear, it's one of these. Is it an argument or a line? Keep calm and search for signs of a game you've played before. We're off to Sproulston, and we think a charity sports day on Blue Ball Lane.
Norfolk News, Norfolk Life. This is BBC Radio Norfolk.
It's 11 o'clock, BBC Radio Norfolk with the news. Here's Lucy Lightfoot.
The Work and Pension Secretary Damian Green has insisted that £100,000 is a reasonable inheritance to have when questioned about his party's proposals to reform social care. Speaking on The Andrew Marr Show on BBC One, Mr Green said the plans outlined in the Conservative manifesto were fair both to pensioners and to working people. But on the same programme, the Shadow Chancellor John McDonnell said the whole benefits system needed to be overhauled as a result of the Tories' approach.
I think the proposals that we'll be putting forward on reform, as we've set out already, will ensure that, in effect, we will be addressing this issue of how we reverse the benefit freeze itself. I want to do it as part of an overall reform package and not just pick off one by one. The issue, look, I tell you, I feel so strongly on this, will deliver this in the first budget.
President Trump is making a speech in Saudi Arabia aimed at rallying Muslims in the fight against religious extremism. Mr. Trump will address a summit of 40 Muslim leaders in Riyadh on the second day of his visit there. The president's aides say today's speech will express a common vision of peace and prosperity. Train bosses say Great Anglia passengers will benefit from 100,000 extra seats. The operator's summer timetable comes into effect today. Extra seating will be on the Cambridge to London line, along with more Wi-Fi. King's Lynn celebrates its European links this weekend with a special festival. The town is part of the Hanseatic League. That's a community of nearly 200 towns across Europe. They see themselves as respectable merchants of modern times. And this weekend, King's Lynn is holding a Hanse Festival. The leader of King's Lynn West Norfolk Borough Council, Nick Daubeny, says the links go back to medieval times.
Yeah, difficult to imagine just how huge that was. 13th, 14th century, King's Lynn, a major player in trading with the Hanse League. And where we're standing would have been crowded with merchants from all over Europe. You'd have heard every language spoken and did great things for the east of England at the time.
Bird experts in Thetford say there's been a higher than expected growth in the population of wild birds for the first time in decades. The latest figures by DEFRA and organisations including the British Trust for Ornithology in Thetford show an increase of 6% in some species. Many in the UK, particularly farmland birds, have been declining since the late 1970s. But the figures show a surprising rise between 2014 and 2015. And the most celebrated circus in the United States is preparing to put on its final performance after 146 years. Owners of the Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus blame declining ticket sales and high operating costs. Activists have campaigned for decades against animal acts in the show. BBC Radio Norfolk News, it's now 3 minutes past 11.
BBC Radio Norfolk weather.
Hello there, just a smattering of cloud today. It's well broken, so we'll get some decent spells of sunshine, and we're expecting a temperature this afternoon of 19 degrees in the centre of Norwich. No need for the brolly, the showers are gone, and the winds are much lighter, so a very pleasant Sunday. Overnight tonight, lots of clear skies once again, but not too chilly. I think we'll just about hold in double figures in the towns, and 8 or 9 degrees across the countryside. So we've got a dry, settled and very warm week ahead. Plenty of sunshine. Just a bit more cloud perhaps on Monday. Warm nights as well. We could be heading up towards the mid-20s at some points this week. Wendy Hurrell with your BBC Radio Norfolk weather.
Treasure Quest on BBC Radio Norfolk.
What's your good morning? Just gone 11 o'clock. It is Julie Ranger in for Sophie this week and me, David Whiteley, as usual. It is Treasure Quest. We do this in every Sunday morning between 9 and 12. We try and get the treasure. And it sounds to me as though you've stopped, Julie. You are there at Sproulston at the Sport and Social Club thing at the charity day.
We're here, but there are a lot of blank faces. There is a lady here. Now, can you just tell me, because we need to find a sport that Sophie has done before. What have you got here today? Because I can't see any rugby.
There's no rugby.
Right.
We do football here.
So has Sophie done football before?
Yes.
Has she done bowls?
Has she done bowls before?
Yes, I think she's done bowls before.
Okay, and what's the other one?
It's petanque.
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 So,
petanque.
I like petanque.
Petanque.
I like petanque. Personally, but boule or petanque.
So, which one of those?
Oh, I don't know.
Has
she done petanque before? I can't remember. I think has she done bowls? I think she's done bowls, like lawn bowls.
So have I just got to go around all of these then? So is this the football here? Hold on a minute. Just for goodness sake. Okay. Hello, guys. Excuse me. Are you doing the football here? Is this a football? No. No.
They're doing a football
thing. No, they're
thing.
Looking they're, blank.
Okay, right, we'll try...
No football.
Try lawn bowls.
I reckon it's Patonk. She's certainly done that before, and I think that's up here.
You think you think Patonk?
He remembers
Come
that.
On, then let's run.
Patonk, I say
that's
potato.
Just hilarious. I didn't even notice. Patonk?
I say potato.
Patonk.
Oh, I didn't know I'd have to run today.
Well, what did I say earlier? You're the, technical.
You're the runner.
Right, where's Patonk, then? Where is it? Where's Patonk?
Boo. It's also known
where's
boo.
The Patonk?
Boo.
Hello? Oh. Any Patonk?
Où est le Patonk? Où est Patonk?
Où est le Patonk? Patonk? Where's the Patonk? Hello? Excuse me, where would I find the Patonk?
The what?
The what? No. At the front, round the front. No. Où est? Okay, come on.
Où est le Patonk?
I really am starting to get nervous. This is involving running, which is never good. Where is it? When they said round the front, I can't see a thing. Empty car park. Here. Well, this is... Oh, hold on. This is where it should be. Oh, right. Oh, okay. So this is where it should be, but it's not. So I don't necessarily have to play, maybe, which I think will be a...
So no. Julie, this will make
you
laugh.
I've run 50 yards and I can't breathe.
Julie, right, this will make you laugh. Yes. While you catch your breath, Jackie on Facebook says this. Best entertainment ever. These two need their own Saturday night TV show.
I
don't know.
I hope the bosses are listening.
Well, that would be great, wouldn't it? Ranger and Whiteley, Saturday
just
Night Live.
Something. Oh, right, what's it going to be called, though?
I don't know.
We're going to argue over this one.
Right,
where's this clue?
Your name can go first. And your name can go first.
Oh, keep calm and play Patonk. And it's yay!
Have you got it?
Sorry, yay!
Good work, everybody. We got it.
I wasn't sure by the high-pitched screaming as to whether Julie actually had the clue, but she has, which is remarkable.
What do you mean it's remarkable?
Okay, highbrow Hannah has joined us as well. And,
I thought as you've just been massacring the French language...
The French language.
I thought I would bring in someone who has lived and worked in France and has a degree in French to tell you properly how to say...
Patonk.
Where is the Patonk?
Oui, la Patonk.
Oui, la Patonk. So that's not bad, was it?
I don't know if you would actually say, like, where is the Patonk?
Okay, how would you say, where is the Patonk area? I see, it stumped you now. Area.
Yeah. No, I know how to say it, but I don't know if you would say that. Let's just keep it. Oui, la
Région Patonk. De la Patonk?
Yeah, all right, David.
Yeah, is that all right? No. The region of the Patonk? No.
Anyway, okay. So here's okay. A professional French speaker.
Hannah, do that again one more time. How do you say it?
Où est la Patonk?
We need to read this clue.
Oh, go on then. You read the clue then. Thank you, Hannah.
Read the clue.
Merci.
Sorry, I don't mean to be rude, but I'm getting slightly twitchy.
Get on with it.
Okay, clue four. Replace the second. Get on with it. Clue four. Replace the second half of an Australian group with something a little more French sounding. Get it back in. Where there are people who sound like hats. Don't go further than the refreshment to notice the clue. So clue four. Replace the second half of an Australian group with something a little more French sounding. Where there are people who sound like hats. Don't go further than the refreshment to notice the clue.
Okay, French, Australian group, in excess. They were Australian group. Questmaster, let's go through clue three quickly. Yeah. Oh dear, it's one of these.
One of those places we always argue over the pronunciation of.
Is an argument or a line.
Yes, is it a row or row, Sprouston or Spruston.
Keep calm and search for signs of a game you've played before.
Yes, I knew it was Joe, but I completely forgot. So I wrote the clues and it was Sophie. But Sophie played Patonk, I think it was earlier this year, was it maybe the Norwich Patonk Club?
Yes, do remember that.
And
it's
the Radio Norfolk Trophy they had there. From
That's right.
Sponsored it 30 years ago.
Many years ago.
And so they got the Keep Calm and Play Patonk posters. Yeah, they got their event there today. I'm sure we'll hear a bit more about what they're doing there at Spruston Sprouston. And maybe they'll give us their thoughts on the name as well. There's clue four, though.
Okay, great.
Oh, and that picture of Julie and all the other pictures up in the gallery. So go to bbc.co.uk/treasure. Or I've put it on the BBC Norfolk Twitter or the Radio Norfolk Treasure Quest Facebook page as well. So you can see Julie in her coat of many colours giving it some welly as she sings.
Or her technical jacket, as she called it. Right, clue four, replace the second half of an Australian group with something a little more French sounding. Well, the only one I can think of off the top of my head is In Excess. The second half would be the excess bit. So maybe something starts with in, with something a little more French sounding, potentially. I mean, it might not be NXS at all. I'm trying to think of Australian groups. Oh, shit, they're Australian. Where there are people who sound like hats. Don't go further than the refreshment to notice the clue. Replace the second half of an Australian group with something a little more French sounding. Where there are people who sound like hats. Don't go further than the refreshment to notice the clue. We're in Sprouston. It's 10 past 11. Panic is setting in. 01603 617 321. 81333. Start your text with the word Norfolk. Get on the Treasure Quest Facebook page. I'm starting to get worried now. At BBC Norfolk on Twitter. This is not looking good. Unless we can solve this within 3 minutes, I think we're gonna struggle. Maria on Facebook says that Julie looks half her age in this picture, but you don't know how old she is. She could be 70.
Hey, you. Just stop it. He's been very rude about me. No, he is.
Maria on Facebook, you look half your age in this picture.
Isn't he?
I know.
We're
a
very, very, very,
very.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Everyone knows how old
exactly.
You are.
Exactly.
Right. There we go.
I don't mind. It's just a number.
Just a number.
Just
a number. Okay. Replace the second half of an Australian group with something a little more French sounding, where there are people who sound like hats. Don't go further than the refreshment to notice the clue. Right. While we're thinking about this, Julie, do you want to find out
what's house?
Going? Crowded house. Replace. Are they Australian?
Which would be maison.
Oh.
No. Yes.
Crowded maison. Replace the second half of an Australian group with something a little more French.
Oh, yeah. Do you want to... Would you like to talk about what's going on here today? Would you? Go on.
Do you want me to do it or you do?
I can tell. The girls are going to argue about who's going to talk.
No.
You could do it as a double act.
Yeah. Okay. We really, well, I don't know where Shez is.
What time does it all start?
It starts, and it started.
Okay.
11 o'clock.
Okay.
Sproulston Sports and Social Club. It's a family day. This is all on behalf of Sproulston Infant School raising money. Also for cancer, the cancer stalls, and there's another stall for the Borneo. And we've got lots of bar open. The bar is open as of 12 o'clock onwards, and hopefully we'll have lots of people coming to us for the day. Thank you.
Oh, well done,
oh,
you. Hold on.
Hang
on. You're going to have a bit more?
Come on,
there's plenty of inflatables down here. We've got Motivate down here with those big insult
force. What is that?
Okay, so,
it's
so
a big
good the
inflatable
signal's going.
Jim, and he will run you through that event. So he'll...
Okay, sounds like the signal's going. Anyway, you know when the event's going on, and it's going on, and it started at 11 o'clock. Right, okay, the top part of this is brilliant. Nikki's in Heacham. Hello, Nikki.
Hello.
What can you do for us?
Here
we go.
Hi, sorry.
What can you do for us quickly?
Well, I don't know if it makes any sense whatsoever, but there's an Australian group called Mountain Down Under, and Man Without Hats, and they sang a song called Mountain Down... what's it called, Simon? Down from Down Under. Men at Work, they were called,
Men at
sorry.
Work, yeah, Men at Work. They did Down Under, didn't they?
Yes, yes.
Okay, that's not a bad idea. Thanks, Nikki. Carol's in Cantley. Good morning.
Good morning, everybody. How are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm all right, thank you.
What do you think?
Well, I wonder if that's ACOR.
Yes,
yes. Is that ACDC,
yes.
Australian?
Yes.
So you got AC,
and then L.
Graham. Yeah.
Then the L on the end.
And the bowlers, the people who hats were bowlers, they could either be bowling or playing cricket.
Oh, is that
bowlers, oh my word, right, that's where we're going. We're going to ACOR, we're not hanging around. Carol, thank you very much.
Thank you. Well done.
Right, Andy on Facebook says the same as well. So does Gary and Diane, have one of those, and so does Daniel. Daniel, you were first there on my screen. Well done. Ingrid in Sheringham, hello.
Hello, you've just reiterated what I was going to say.
That's great, I'd trust you. Thousands wouldn't, Ingrid. I'd normally get you to show me you're working, but we're running out of time. Ingrid, thank you very much. Right, OK, you're heading for ACOR then.
Oh.
Julie.
Right,
they were very quick there. Everyone's been very quick. Daniel on Facebook was very fast. We're going to go to ACOR. Nigel. Hello, Nigel.
ACOR.
Hello, David.
Hello, mate. How are you?
I wonder if they've got to go to Coldham Hall.
Why do you think that?
They've got an open day on there today, Royal Yacht Association.
Okay. What's that got to do with it?
People who sound like hats. Boaters.
Boaters. Oh, yeah. Straw boaters. Mm. That's not a bad idea. I like the idea of ACOR, though, you see. Because you've got the AC/DC,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, Australian band, replace the second half with something a little more French sounding.
Are we definitely going to
ACOR?
Yeah. Yeah, see what I mean?
Yep.
No, I think we're
going
to go with that, Nigel. Thanks for your call, buddy. Right, we're going for ACOR. I'm happy with ACOR.
Are you sure?
I'm standing by ACOR.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Okay.
We're in the car and we're moving.
Now, back not... road or...
A back road or A47?
Well, I go for the
A47. David, we can...
I go for the A47.
David's saying A47, so we'll trust David.
I'd say go, yeah, because you're going to pick up the A1042, which is the outer ring road, as you come back in from Sprowston. And then you want to pick... I then just... You then head on the A47 for Acle.
Okay. How long have we got? What time is it?
It's quite a way, actually. I really hope this is right. Having said that, it's quite a way. I mean, it's probably good. It's probably 10 minutes.
10 minutes away,
10, 15
okay.
Minutes,
what time is it now?
Quarter past. So it's...
Quarter past. Oh, we'll be fine.
It's doable.
It'll be fine. So when we get to Acle, where are we going?
Well,
sorry, we were
where there are people who sound like
headsets.
Yeah, where there are people who sound like hats. So you'd have a bowler hat. So it might be somebody, a cricket, somebody who's bowling for cricket. Or maybe they're doing lawn bowls.
Paul, was it Coddenham Hall?
No, not that. Forget that. We're going for Acle. And we're going to go for, I imagine, the recreation ground there. So maybe there's something going on in Acle today. And if somebody knows, give us a buzz. 01603 617321.
There are people who sound like hats.
Yes, because they sound like
don't
a bowler.
Don't go further
hat.
Than the refreshments to notice the clue. Mm.
So maybe there's a refreshment tent. And don't go any further than that.
Okay.
See what I mean?
Right. Yeah. I do.
Oh, you are funny.
Oh, it's got to that stage.
It's got like that, has it? It's got like that, has it, Jules?
I need a bit of peppermint. Yeah, it's got to be like that, love. All wait, right. I'm going to have some of my tea.
You have some of your tea. You have some of your tea. Does Graham know how to get to Acle from
cold
there?
Cold is nice. Graham, do you know how to get to Acle?
Well, there's the old road to Acle, which is windy, that saves us getting onto the Southern Bypass or out to Posick. It's either or, I suppose.
Did you hear that, David?
What do you want to do?
Acle Road.
We're just about to get on the old Acle Road. Do you want to stay on this?
Through Thorpe End and all of that. It's windy, but it does take us, I think it's less miles.
Do you want to take the long and windy road? David, what should we do?
We know a song about that.
It's the road that goes through Thorpe End and South Walsham and
Portsmouth. Oh, I know. Yeah. Yeah, go for that. Do you know that really well? Does he know that really well? Do you know it well enough to take that? Because I would have taken that. I do know that road, but I would have...
We're virtually on it.
Stick with that, then. Stick with that. Richard in Necton.
But what we really need to know is where we're going once we get there.
Okay, hang on. We're about to get a call, apparently. Questmaster's told me. Yeah. This is Brian. Brian's on the line. Good morning, Brian.
Good morning, everybody.
You're very jolly, Brian.
Just to let you know, it's Acle Regatta today at Acle Bridge, where you'll find a beer tent and a barbecue.
Acle Regatta.
It is.
And whereabouts is that?
It's at Acle Bridge.
Acle Bridge, thank you.
Acle Bridge?
Yeah, it is. It's celebrating 40 years of Acle Regatta.
40 years of Acle Regatta?
Yeah, it restarted 40 years ago.
Do you know what? There's nothing wrong with being 40. I think 40 is the new 30.
No, I agree with that.
As, yeah, you know.
70 is the new 50.
So that means you're the new 40 then?
Yeah, something like that.
Brian, thank you very much. We're going to Acle Bridge. So how do we get to Acle Bridge? How far is it from Acle itself?
Only a mile.
Only a mile.
On the 1064.
Okay, hold on.
On the 1064.
Yep.
We have to stay on the 1064.
Well, once you get to...
It's about a mile out.
It is.
Hold on. Do you know Acle Bridge? Oh, brilliant.
He does know Acle Bridge. Excellent. It's because you come off the roundabout there, isn't it? Brian, thank you very much. Have one of these. Top man.
Oh, thanks, Brian.
Thanks, Brian.
Brilliant.
Thank you, buddy. Cheers, mate. Bye-bye. Jill from Acle says the regatta as well. And, of course, Bob says straw hats boater. And that's what Nigel said too. So Nigel needs one of those as well because Nigel was the first to say that. But we're going to be sent somewhere else. So, Julie, goodness me.
Yes.
Yeah, it's exhausting.
But then we've got to find the clue. And so I need to... Do you think the refresh...
Yeah, refreshment. The refreshment bit. Because Brian said there was a beer tent as well. Okay, anyway, you know where you're going, and it started off with AC/DC, so we need a bit of this, don't we? Because it's good driving music. For people who sound like hats, boaters, straw boaters, don't go further than the refreshment to notice the clue. It was Brian that called up to say that they're celebrating the 40th anniversary, or when they restarted the Acle Regatta 40 years ago, and we're heading for Acle Bridge. Aren't you, Julie?
We are. We had to stop for a train, though.
Oh, did you? Where was it? On the road?
Yeah. random train passing.
Random train passing.
Yeah, so now we're on our way. How much further? How much further? What, 10? You're kidding me. 10 miles.
No, surely not. Really?
Really? Mm-hmm. He's actually nodding his head.
Okay. Well, Peter says that from the B1140, it says A1140, but I mean, it's B1140, there's a road that cuts through to the A1064, which will help you out. So,
oh, there's a cut through.
Yeah, the back road I think you're on is the B1140.
One. Is it
Acle
Bridge?
You need Acle Bridge, yeah. He knows that. Okay. Acle Bridge, I've got it here.
He's on it.
He's on it.
Hooray for the last one.
He's on it like a car bonnet.
It's taken us all programmed to get all done.
Are you getting your own back on Graham because of the picture he took of you singing?
No, it's been brilliant. It's been lovely. Great fun. And everyone's been fantastic today.
It's been lovely.
Because if I was reliant on myself to...
If you're reliant on yourself to what? Dear, we lost the signal. I tell you what, we'll try and get Julie on the phone because I think they must be going through a bit of a dark... Oh, no, we got you back. No, yes, no, no, yes, yes, no.
Oh, hello.
Yeah, got you back. You were about to say something rather poignant and then the signal dipped.
Oh, I doubt it.
Okay, well, we know they've got quite a way to go yet, so we'll catch up with them in a minute. Because there's quite a few miles to go yet. 25 past 11, half an hour before we have to have... the treasure. Will we, won't we? Don't know. There are quite a few miles. They're not going to be there till probably another 10 minutes yet. And then we've got to get the clue 5. And then we've got to solve clue 5. Oh. We live in hope. Nick Kershaw, The Riddle. Another rap song. for Treasure Quest here on BBC Radio Norfolk, nearly 11:30.
It's got to be negotiating something sensible with the rest of the European Union and realise that we're not going to have it all our own way.
Well, I think it's about the NHS, because I'm a nurse, so I think it would help with all the work we do, anything with not getting any extra pay.
The economy. Brexit is going to have an impact because of the exchange rate and how it affects the average man on the street and the population in general. And debt. I'm a bit worried about debt.
Still haven't made your mind up yet? Here at BBC Radio Norfolk, we'll be helping you make sense of the election. We'll be hosting debates, asking the questions you want answers to, finding out the facts, and meeting the people that will be shaping our future in Norfolk. Keep listening for more. Election 2017 with BBC Radio Norfolk. You're part of the BBC. Treasure Quest on BBC Radio Norfolk.
It is virtually exactly 11:30, so we've got 25 minutes before we have to have the treasure. Julie has to have the treasure in 25 minutes' time. So we're on clue four. Replace the second half of an Australian group with something a little more French-sounding. So the Australian group AC/DC, so you take off the DC and replace it with something a little more French-sounding, and you get le, so acl. Where there are people who sound like hats and went after boaters, boater hats. Don't go further than the refreshment to notice the clue. So we're going for Acl Bridge, where they're having the Acl Regatta, the 40th anniversary of the relaunch of the Acl Regatta. So don't go further than the refreshment to notice the clue. Maybe the refreshment tent. We're struggling to get a signal to the radio car at the moment. So we know that they were sort of winging their way by the back roads to get to Acl. Graham is definitely navigating and doing very well. I think we've got you on
Hello.
The line. We've got you. How are you doing?
Yay! Right, we're just going through South Walsham, so we're about 3 miles away. And I had forgotten, we're not looking for the treasure now, are we? This is clue five and then the treasure.
Yeah.
I thought we were heading towards the treasure.
That's wishful thinking, Julie.
Hey, I know. So I had a little moment where I was like, well, we're doing really well. And Graham's like, you know, we've got another. And I was like, really?
I know, don't.
Really? Okay. So it looks like they're having some kind of yard sale here today.
Yeah, lots of houses.
With stuff outside to sell. It's so gorgeous out here. Mm. Sorry, David. I know
you're
in the
studio.
No,
fine. Yeah, but it swings and roundabouts, though, isn't it? Because when the weather's bad, I'm in the best place.
Yeah, I guess it swings both ways. Right. How much further? Acl, 2 3/4.
Okay, well, that's not too bad. We'll hold the line. Hopefully, we'll keep the signal.
Okay. Oh, right.
How are your energy levels doing?
I'm flagging a bit.
I thought you were. I had noticed a decline in the amount of chatter.
What's your mouth about?
I kind of realised that things had kind of gone south. I can hear you.
What was that about gone south?
I said I could tell that your energy levels had gone south by the fact that you were chatting less.
Oh, really? Really? I don't know what you're saying. Here, we've got a fruit juice we can share. Want to share a fruit juice?
There's no chocolate in there, is there? No chocolate?
No chocolate, just some plain biscuits. We were being this week. Got an apple, but that'll get stuck in our teeth.
Oh, that's no good. Apple's good, but you'll need a bit of a sugar boost, I think, to keep me going to the end. We've only got 23 minutes before we have to have the treasure, and we've got to solve clue five yet. Got to get there, get clue five. So we could still do it. We could still do it. I'm still optimistic because they're a couple of miles away from Acl. The signal is a bit in and outy. But they should be there very soon. It's 11:33 coming up. I don't know whether we have to do anything when we get there. I think that hopefully some kind person by the refreshment tent will just be there with a brown envelope, hand it over to Julie. We can have a quick chat about the regatta. Read through clue five. Solve it like lightning. And then be on our way to get the treasure. Maybe it's nearby. Maybe it'll be nearby. I don't know. We got you again, kid. No, she really has flagged now. She's not even talking to me now. She's gone to sleep. We got the signal, but she's asleep. Oh, she's...
Oh. Yeah.
What are you eating?
Right, we've been there. Treasure Quest on bike. Can you ride a motorbike?
What are you eating? Can they not hear me?
Oh, that would be...
They have to get there on air. Oh, they've lost us. This is quite interesting. We could just listen.
We could wear a shiny helmet like that. Actually,
we could just listen. We could just eavesdrop on their conversation because I think they've lost the signal to us. so they can't hear us. They were having a private conversation then while Julie was eating.
Oh, hello, are you back?
And they mentioned someone with a shiny helmet. That's all I heard. And then I don't know whether they can hear us or not, but it's always interesting to eavesdrop. Can you hear me?
Oh, hello.
Oh, hello. Are we on the radio? I thought it was just between us. I thought we were having a conversation.
Sorry. It's quite hard to remember sometimes.
You remember that you're on air. What are you
in and out.
What are you eating?
Biscuit. They're just kind of gluten-free.
All right.
Biscuit. Well,
how many have you had?
I've had two. Graham's still on his first one because I'm having to feed him.
Well, he's driving. He's doing very well. So you were a couple of miles from Acol just now, so you should see the
Where
bright lights
now?
Of Acol.
We're just coming into Acol.
Are we coming into Acol? Quick, I've got to finish this biscuit.
30 mile an hour, just down the head, just down the line.
We've finished
Acol High School.
Okay. Where's we're just passing the high school.
Okay.
Sorry, this is very rude eating on the radio.
It's fine. We do anything on the show.
That final boost. How far are we from the bridge? A mile from the bridge. Okay. We can do this. We can do this.
We can do it.
I heard
the questmaster's been very kind.
I have every faith. Well, hopefully the treasure won't be too far from where we are, but we've got to solve that last clue, and you've got to get it first.
I felt we were on a roll, and then suddenly the time's just disappeared.
No, I know. I find that. I've done this show a year now, and I can tell you, you kind of think, oh, we've got plenty. No, we haven't got plenty of time.
So I don't feel so bad at screaming at you down the line. Can we just read the clue?
You shouldn't feel bad.
I felt a little bit rude at that point. I felt I owed you an apology, but now actually...
Never. You'll never owe me an apology. It's fine. We're doing our late night TV show together on...
I know. That's exciting, isn't it? Have we thought of a title? I've got to think of a tune. If we get the treasure, we've got to get the treasure because I want a request.
Oh, I think you're going to think of a tune for our theme tune for our TV show.
We could have that. Let's do that. The request could be our theme tune. What would it be?
Smile by Lily Allen. No idea.
Do you think so? Nah. Sorry, having a drink now.
Yes, that's fine.
I'm so sorry, everyone.
You have your breakfast.
Everyone sat at home. Oh, dear. Great radio.
It is.
Oh, how much fun?
Come on. Cheers. For goodness sake.
We're virtually there. We're coming up to the 10:64.
I've got to
right, come on.
Down.
Get ready to go, Julie.
Oh,
finish what's
gosh.
In your mouth. You can't speak to people with your mouth full. You'd be spraying them with gluten-free biscuits.
Very rude. Hold on. I've got bits stuck in my teeth now.
Oh,
for
goodness sake. You're conjuring up a wonderful image.
No. I've then got to get out of the car. I'm going to do one of the switcheroos where I don't get stuck. I've not managed one.
I don't think Sophie's ever managed that. It's very tricky. It's a tricky technique
to
master.
That makes me feel better. There's lots of people walking in this direction. Right. Now, how easy do you think the parking's going to be when we get there?
I think just go for it. Just run.
Just leave the car. Stop the car. I've done that before.
And you know we have
just
to find the...
I'll get out and run.
That's all over there, isn't it? That's
Julie?
Is that it there? Oh, wow!
The refreshment, The refreshment tent. Hello? Refreshment tent, yes.
Refreshment tent.
And then just get that clue
and
read
it. You can see the shark
it.
Fins already.
Shark fins?
You know when you see the sails and they look like shark fins?
Oh, yeah, of course they do. What on earth are you talking about?
Sorry, on the Broads.
Yeah. White sharks. On the Broads.
Let's tent. Do you think that's... Yeah. Is that a refreshment tent?
Regatta car park.
Next left. If you don't want to go in the car park, we need special parking. No, there's a man. There's a man waving. And now all the cars in front think that they can go into the regatta this way.
By the special
entrance. Sorry, no, only us. Here we go. Yes. Put your carton down.
We've got 2 minutes before the travel. So if you can get it read before the travel,
right,
that'd be great. Go. Come on.
Okay. Focus. Hold on a minute.
Focus.
Right, so we're just literally running parallel with the water now. And where's a tent? There's a tent over there. Right, head for that corner, Graham, and then I'm literally going to run. I'm going to swap headphones now, but I'm just going to keep talking.
Okay, well done.
So I'm going to sound miles off.
Always prepared.
And I'm going to grab this, and I'm going to grab that. You have to press a button, don't you, for me to be on this. Switcheroonie, come on.
Switcheroonie now, okay.
I'm just going to start
They're there at the Acol Regatta. She's switching over. We've got to get clue five. We've got 16 minutes before we have to have the treasure.
The refreshment tent. Hello, hi. Hello, hi, Claire. How are you? Fancy seeing you. Where's this clue? Where's this clue? Good morning. Right, refreshments. Beer. 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 What's okay, refreshments. Where are we? Hold on. Oh, there's a sign. Acle Sailing Club. Clue
five. You got
a
clue five. Nice one.
Good work, everybody. We got it.
Oh. Quickly, Julie, read it, read it, read it.
Oh, hello. Okay, I'm going to read it.
Well done, well done.
Everyone.
So fast. Good girl. Nice one. Good girl.
Good girl.
I didn't mean a good girl.
Don't get
talking to my
good
children.
Girl, gold star. Clue five. A topical family interrupts a Warwickshire village with a mouse. Sorry. David Whiteley's just called me a good girl, everyone. Okay. Stop it. Stop laughing. Sorry. Take me out of my headphones because I can't do this.
Go on, do it. I'll shut up.
Okay, stop. Okay. Clue five. A topical family interrupts a Warwickshire village where the maps can be found. Seek out the final frontier. Okay, everybody, listen to this. A topical family interrupts a Warwickshire village where the map can be found. Seek out the final frontier.
Well, the final frontier is space is the final frontier in Star Trek. Space is the final frontier.
Right, isn't it?
Julie, can I say, I'm sorry I called you a good girl. I'm sorry. Right, OK, let's go through clue four quickly, Questmaster, before we go to the travel.
Okay.
Replace the second half of an Australian group with something a little more French-sounding.
AC/DC, so le, so acle.
Where there are people who sound like hats.
Boaters.
Straw boaters. Don't go further than the refreshment to notice the clue.
Yeah, they've got the refreshment area there where they have the clue pinned up. Thanks to Gary for putting it there. I'm sure he'll give us a quick word about the regatta. There's your copy, but time for the travel.
Thank you very much. Well, let me just read it really quickly before we go to the travel. I'm going to read it really quickly as well.
Sorry,
it's only been waiting a minute. Clue five. Thank you, Questmaster. A topical family interrupts a Warwickshire village where the maps can be found. Seek out the final frontier. Space was the final frontier in Star Trek. What about the rest of it? 01603 617321. We've got 14 minutes to get this sold and get Julie to the treasure. 01603 617321. Get on the Facebook page at BBC Norfolk on Twitter.
BBC Radio Norfolk Travel.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Howard, but here you are.
That's OK. Well, firstly, on the A47, there's no delays running across there, so that's all moving fine, as well as the A12. In Nordelf, we've got electric works and temporary lights on Downham Road in both directions. In East Dereham, there are electric works and also some temporary lights on Yaxham Road at the A1075. In Borough Castle, Lord's Lane is shut today for waterworks between Mill Road and Laurel Drive. The train's not reporting any delays heading into and out of Norwich. And we also have the ongoing Norwich and Norfolk Festival, which takes place today around the city centre. Now, if you see anything or can update me, call 01603 617 321. I'm Howard Kassam with your BBC Radio Norfolk Travel.
Okay, this is clue five. We've got 13 minutes. Solve it, get Julie to the treasure. A topical family interrupts a Warwickshire village where the maps can be found. Seek out the final frontier. Well, James T. Kirk in his Starlog or Spacelog said space, the final frontier. A topical family could be the Trump family, maybe. I don't know. Throwing ideas out there. What do you think? 01603 617321. Can you do it? Can you do it? You normally do. Give us a buzz. We need to get Julie to the treasure. Right,
my
Julie.
Pleasure.
Julie.
Hello.
Julie, you good girl. Fine.
Yes. Yes.
I'm so sorry. I did not mean that to sound patronising. I just meant good one and a good girl, because I'm so used to saying it to my daughters, obviously.
Do we need to head back to the car? Have we got any idea?
No idea yet. No.
Idea.
Do you want to have
now,
a
where's
quick,
the gentleman?
Do you have a
there was
chat
a gentleman
about the
here. You thought South. The South Walsham, you thought, didn't you? Why did you think South Walsham?
It's the third line, the way you can get the maps from. I know there's you pass the yard sale in South Walsham on your way out.
Oh.
I can't put South Walsham in the first two. Hopefully Daniel can, because he's good at this sort of thing.
He is.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Do you want to find out about the regatta quickly? Do you want to find out about the regatta?
Yeah, let me tell me a little bit about this. Sorry, you, sir, just explain to your role.
Yes, I'm Commodore. This is ACLE, our 40th ACLE regatta. Consecutive. It was raced years ago. There was a regatta in the late 1800s, early 1900s. Then it stopped. And in 1977, a group of us local sailors over in the Bridge pub decided to revive it. And we've done it for 40 years consecutively. yeah. And so.
And is this and the race coming in
there's
now?
There's a race coming now. All the boats, all the sails you can see across the marshes there. We've got 17, they're all traditional cruisers, sailing cruisers, some up to 100 years old themselves. And you can see a fantastic sight with our topsails up. And yeah, so this has been the pursuit race, which takes them right down nearly to St. Bennet's Abbey and back to Acle, which is...
Oh, how wonderful. So literally... Oh, sorry, Graham, what?
Someone's just whispered in my ear. Apparently there is a South Walsham in Warwickshire.
Oh, right, come okay. On. All right. Well, I think we might be going. Lovely to see you
right
all.
Then, let's
take
roll.
Care.
Let's roll.
Okay. Bye, Claire. So nice to see you. Do you remember Claire, who used to work in the office? She's here.
Yes, I do remember Claire. Hello,
yes.
Claire. Give her a
love. Claire.
I know
David
Claire.
Says hello, Claire. And goodbye.
I do know.
Don't drop your sunglasses. Okay.
So you're going to go for South Walsham, where the maps can be found, because...
Right, whereabouts? So where the maps are found.
So if it's a yard sale, if it's a yard sale or a garage sale, you'll have one place where they sell the maps. Okay, so I can't remember who said that, but I have one of these anyway. Thank you to the people at the Acle Regatta. Sounds like they're having a lovely time. She's getting ready.
Where's the other headphones?
Oh, my word, we've got 10 minutes.
Here we go.
Julie, you've done
right.
Hello, well done.
Right, we can
well
do this.
Done.
So, where are the maps? We need somebody to phone in to tell, or Facebook in, or anything in.
Any
just
me.
Just tell us where we get the maps from. Not now, darling.
Not now, Viv.
Come on.
Julie's right. 01603 617321. Where are the maps in
running.
South Walsham? The most running you've done in months.
No, and I'm very unfit. I have to do something about this. It's ridiculous.
You said that
every
in February.
Every time I come on this programme. I know, and I've said it the February before that. And the February before that.
And you will next time.
We need to know where the maps were, because we just saw the people selling stuff.
Yeah, loads of people selling stuff in that front garden.
But
you
mentioned
that.
We need to know where they've got the maps.
Well, hopefully.
How much longer have we got?
9 minutes.
9 minutes. 9 minutes.
That,
okay.
The site, that was a beautiful site. It would have been nice to have soaked that up a little more.
We're getting calls in, Julie, which is
can
good.
Can you see?
Yeah.
Okay, we're just concentrating because the road's really busy. So, can you see all right, Graham?
Yeah, fine,
okay. Right. Hurrah. Okay, so we're on the main road now, which is quite busy, and we just need to know where you pick up the map.
And
in South
Graham
Walsham.
Has been brilliant behind the wheel today, but does he know where South Walsham, how to get back to South Walsham? He's happy with that, is he?
You know how to get back to South Walsham, yeah.
Yeah, good,
David
okay.
was just saying how brilliant you've been. You have been.
Well,
it has
yet.
Been. You know, we haven't. Look, he's such a professional. We're not done yet.
Oh, no, just saying. Thus far.
Thus far. Can you hear us all right? Sorry,
yeah,
the signal
you're
keeps
clear,
dropping
you're clear.
In and out.
You're clear as
loud
that.
And clear.
Crystal clear. We got you.
Oh, this is exciting, isn't it?
Yeah, it gets your blood going, doesn't it? Gets your heart pumping.
Yeah, it does. I'm going. I just want... We've got to do this. We
come
can
on,
do this.
Anne is on the line. Good morning, Anne. Can you help us?
Hi, everyone. The maps are available from the Village Hall, which is in School Road.
Village Hall.
On School Road.
School Road.
Yeah,
is
I can't
on
help...
Main Road?
I have absolutely no idea.
I'll look it up on my little map. There will be no use whatsoever.
Yeah. Okay, David.
Thank you, Anne.
Bye-bye.
Take care. Bye-bye. Have one of these before
bye.
You go. Have one of those. Oh, my word.
Bye.
Oh, so frantic,
right,
this show
thank
sometimes.
You so much. Thank you.
Okay, School Road in Ooh. South Walsham.
Village Hall
you want. School Road.
Okay. Have
Ooh.
You found it?
No, I'm not.
Listen to me. Have you got it? There? What? You haven't done it yet? Come on. You will be gone by the time we get back.
Yeah.
Although after the good girl comment, you might have to be
have
making
to
it sharp.
I might have to run.
Yeah.
I might have to disappear.
Good
fast.
Girl.
Good girl. I didn't mean it like that.
Like some racehorse.
I'll go pat you on your neck. Good girl. Good girl.
Yeah, let's not go
anyway,
there.
Have a sugar
Thanks.
Cube. Have a sugar
yeah.
cube. Have a sugar cube.
Thanks.
Right.
Thanks, babes.
Yeah, have a peppermint tea.
Well, we're on the South Walsham Road, which is good.
Okay.
But we're just still in Acle. And there is quite a lot of traffic.
Peter says, take
How
a right-hand turn for his shortcut this time. He was the guy that earlier said about the B11 footage. But I think you know where you're going, and I'm reluctant to throw anything else in there. We've got 7 minutes.
7 minutes. Mm. We can do this. We can... Oh, Graham's going... Oh, don't make that sound.
Oh, no.
We literally just got to find that village hall. Have you found it yet? Have you found it?
School Road.
School Road, Village Hall.
Yeah, got it. Well, there's a school road.
In the map box.
Yeah, I've got it. It's got here. The
Fairhaven.
Okay. Well, as you you're going to come in on the South Walsham Road, which becomes Newport Road. You're going to turn into Burlingham Road. Then which becomes
on the left or the right?
It'd be on your right hand side.
A right hand turn into Burlingham Road.
Yeah. Oh, hang on. You're coming from Acle. Sorry, I take that back. Sorry.
Okay, there's two.
I'm looking at the other South Walsham Road. No, I hadn't. There's two South Walsham Roads. Right, so South Walsham Road becomes Acle Road. Yep. So you're on the South Walsham Road now. Right. So you've come out of Acle, yeah?
We're coming out of Acle.
Okay, are you going past a place called Fishley Barn Farm?
Fishley Barn Farm.
Should be on your right.
Was that?
You passed that sign, have you?
Have we? Okay, yes, we have.
Okay, you've got, and then you have you gone Rain past the turning? You should have gone past the right-hand turn for Church Road. Gone past that?
Hold on, that might be this one coming up. Is this a right-hand turn to Church?
Don't
Road?
Go in it. But I just want to know where you are. I'm not going to stop.
No, we're not going to go in. We're just trying to identify.
Well done.
So this is a turning into.
This is the Upton Road.
That's the Upton Road.
Okay, now carry on. That should be Church Road.
Okay.
The next road will be Hanging Hill, but go past that.
Hanging Hill on the left, is that?
No, that should be on your right-hand side.
How is it?
I might find myself there again if I call you a good girl.
We're just passing the Windle. The Windle. I'm never ever going to let you forget this.
No, I'm sure you won't.
We've just passed the Windle.
Good. You've gone past the Windle.
Oh, Hanging Hill. Yeah. We've just passed Hanging Hill on the right. Oh, come on. Time is just...
Okay. The next...
Supermarket delivery van.
You want to turn right... Listen. You want to turn... Listen, Julie.
I'm listening.
Good girl. The next turning...
Bad boy.
You're coming to Green Lane. And you want to turn right.
Oh, really?
You want to turn right, okay.
We want to turn right down Green Lane?
Yeah, we want to turn
Are
right.
Are you serious?
The next road coming up. The next right.
Okay.
You've gone past Hanging Hill, right?
Yeah, we've gone past Hanging Hill, and we now need to go Green Lane, he's saying, is on the right. We haven't passed
right,
the right-hand turning
and
yet,
then
have we?
Then you're going to go past County
Hold
Farm.
Hold on, Green Lane. Oh, it's not a turn. It's a bend in the road.
Oh, it's a bend in the road. Right, fine, okay.
Oh, no, there's a bend in the... Green Lane is on the left.
Yeah, you don't want that. You want the right-hand turn. Right-hand turn.
Oh no! So yeah. So we just stay on the bend.
Okay. And then you're going to take your next left.
Okay.
And then you want to pick up Field Road, and that leads you round the bend into School Road.
Okay. We're going on to Acle Road now, which is just the continuation. Oh my goodness! We've got a cyclist and a supermarket delivery van. We're not moving very fast.
3 minutes. We've got 3 minutes.
We're going very slowly. How long?
Three minutes.
No! Please. Oh, no, drive very safely.
I don't
obviously.
Like this. I hate this.
Oh, we're just going at 5 miles an hour.
So you got Field Road.
Hey, cyclists. No way. I don't know where we are.
Get out of the way.
Stop.
You mammals. Get out of the way.
There's a cyclist, and now no one can get past the cyclist. And are we going to get past the cyclist?
Oh,
yes, we
sick.
Are.
Right, okay, Field Road. Have you got Field Road yet?
Field Road. Do we need to turn right?
Yeah, go to
right
Field
down
Road.
Field
it's
Road,
Field
yes.
Road, and that road right, bends yes. to the left into School Road.
Oh, right, okay. So it bends, okay. Here we go. So we're on Field Road.
Yeah, the next left, or if it might just be a bend into the left.
The next
that
left
is School
is
Road.
What, sorry?
That is School
That's
Road.
That's School Road. So the next left is what we want.
School and village,
road,
and the village hall is on School Road.
And then we need the village hall. Okay.
Oh,
right.
Come on, Julie.
Oh, this
come
blinking.
On, Graham.
I don't even want to take the headset. Right, where? How on? I don't want to get stuck in the car.
Oh, I feel.
Right, okay.
I feel faint.
I'm taking my headphones off and detangling them now.
Have you? Can you? Are you in School Road yet?
Is that even a word?
Are you in School Road?
Oh, is this School Lane?
School Road.
School Road. Right. School Road.
Look at the village hall. We've got 2 minutes, Julie. 2 minutes.
2 minutes. We've got 2 minutes, Graham. 2 minutes.
Oh man, this is to the wire.
Where is it?
To the wire.
To the wire, okay. I don't know why I'm repeating everything. Just everything you say, I'll just repeat back for no apparent reason. Oh, and it might help if I have the microphone near my mouth. Okay. So it is, where is it?
I don't know. That's it. School Road, Village Hall is on School Road.
Is that the Village Hall? Is there something? Right, I've literally got a minute and a half. Is that it?
Minute and a half.
No, that's just another person selling.
Sorry, that sounds awful. That's
Village Hall,
that's
come on. Where is it?
Where is it? We don't
Seek
know.
Seek out the final frontier. Space. Space is what you're looking for.
Space. So where is it? Is this the school? Is this it? South Walsham Church of England School?
Yeah, but
That's the actual school.
You want the village hall.
Is it? Stop, hold on.
That's Fairhaven.
That's Fairhaven.
Well, where's the village hall then? It should be there.
We don't know.
You've come to the end of the road. That's the end of the school.
Okay, we've got to turn round.
Where is the village hall?
It must have been it.
Must have been
Where's the village hall? Was
Wendy
that it?
Wendy says the village hall is on the left-hand side. So you must have gone past it.
That must have been the school, do you think? Okay, look.
Oh, hang on. I haven't hit the countdown. Yeah. We've got a minute! Oh, we've got a minute!
A minute! Okay, let's turn the car.
Oh, I hate this. I don't believe this.
Oh, hold on.
Dangerous.
No, we're going to have to go over. We're not going to do it, are we?
50.
50 seconds. Oh, no! No, I don't want to hear that. You failed. We can do this, can we? Can
40.
We? No, 40 seconds.
Well, I can't believe you went past
Wait,
the village hall.
We're turning the car.
Can't believe.
It was a school. It just said it was a school, didn't it? We've not seen.
Well, is that it? Not seen the village hall. Are you the end of School Road? Oh.
So is that? Ah, okay. We're on the right. Is that the school? I just thought it said a school.
It did say school.
It did say.
Just go for
the village hall. Village hall. There we are. There's a sign.
Quick.
Tabletop. There we go. Quick. We get. Okay. How long? It's longer. Quick.
10, 15 seconds.
We're not even stopped yet. Oh,
10 seconds. Just get out and run.
Yeah, I'll stop the car. Just stop. I'm running. Oh, stop these headphones.
3, 2, 1.
You are kidding me.
Hello. Hi. Where do I pick a map up from? Is the map?
Too late. Is it too late?
Where are the maps? Where's the maps?
Julie, we're too late.
Oh, no. We are too late. Hello. Would it be all right to have some treasure, please?
Oh, I can't believe it. We're not allowed the treasure, are we?
No, because it's the 300th treasure and you still haven't got it.
We still haven't got it.
Okay.
Julie, that was so close. Well done.
No. Yes. Is that treasure? It's the treasure.
We're not allowed it, though.
No,
Have we found it?
But bring it back here, because I need to send it out for next week now.
Right, where's the treasure? Let's find it.
She can't
treasure.
Have it. She can't.
Well, no, because they can bring it back.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Julie.
Where's the treasure? Oh, there it is. There's a whole amazing display of the universe. And underneath the rocket is the treasure.
I don't believe it. Julie.
Sorry.
Julie, you've done so well today.
Well, as you're there, you better grab a little chat with them about the garage sale and the display and what's going on.
Have a chat with them, Julie. Yeah.
Let's just hold on. We're just going to grab a photograph and then hopefully there's somebody who can talk to me.
Shall I explain the clue to you, David, while we...
Let's go through the clue while we're doing some pictures.
Someone got... I don't know if you had time to read it out, but I did... Tina on Facebook got that the Topical Brothers, or the Topical Families, the Walsh Brothers, of course.
Oh, of course,
and in Warwickshire, the boxers from Cromer who were fighting both of them yesterday. And there's a village in Warwickshire called Southam, or Southam, I'm not sure how they pronounce it, but if you put Walsh into Southam or Southam, you get South Walsham, you see?
Oh, man.
And
where the maps can be found.
Yeah, the maps for the garage sale on sale at the hall there. And in the hall also is a display all about space and the universe, which I think the local school have done.
Yeah.
But Julia isn't allowed to open the treasure room. She has to bring it back and leave it on my desk because it's the curse of the 300th win. You can't seem to get the 300th win. So we'll see if Anna can get it when she stands in for Sophie next week.
Questmaster, it's been a pleasure as usual.
Well, thank you.
It's a shame we were so close. And Julie and I have had lots of fun today.
You have.
I think it's been lots of fun.
Yeah.
But anyway. Oh.
Oh, dear.
Is there someone that you can have a chat with, Julie? Or do you want me to come back to you after
Don't apologise. You've been brilliant. You've been a good girl.
Thanks. You've not been bad either.
We've done all right. Listen, do you want to have a quick chat with them and find out about the garage sale?
Yeah, no, that would be lovely.
Okay.
Hello, what's your name?
Talia.
Hello, Talia. Do you know what's happening today? Can you tell me? Is this a garage sale? So what do people do?
They buy stuff.
Do they? And do they buy it just from here or can they go and visit people at their houses? They can visit people at their houses. She's nodding. So this is a good... So what do we have to do, Mum?
So it's a garage sale today and raising funds for the Fairhaven Preschool here in South Walsham that runs from the village hall here.
Okay, so what time can people come along till?
Till 2, I believe, today. So it's been going on since 9:30. Maps and refreshments in the hall, all raising funds for the preschool.
So come here first, pick up your map and then take a
And if you get a map today as well, you get entered into a prize draw.
Lovely. And what's the prize?
Oh, I can't remember actually.
Something good.
I think it's a meal voucher.
Oh, brilliant. Yeah. Excellent. So, well, have afternoon. Thank you so much
for having us there.
I
didn't get there quite in time.
I'm not allowed to open this. Do you think I should be able to open it? She's nodding. Yeah.
The question, what's that question?
You've got a beautiful dress.
It's the treasure for the 300th win.
Right,
it's
so
one
we can't
I had it. Made specially, and you haven't got the 300th
no,
win.
No, we can't open it, Julie. Julie, thank you so much. It's been a pleasure.
Oh, well, thank you to Graham. Graham, thank you so
well
much.
Done, Graham.
Top team.
It's my fault entirely. I take full responsibility.
It's been great.
It was so close.
It was so close. Never mind. Julie, thanks ever so much. And, well, we'll be reunited for our late night TV show.
I'm looking forward to it. And I don't get the request, do I?
No, you don't. Maybe next time, when you come back next time, when you say you're unfit again. Julie, thanks ever so much. Questmaster, extra time after 12.
Yes, photos. Perhaps great ones you've taken, unfortunate ones that have been taken of you. And.